This is everything spicy. So, hey, I'm 5 minutes early. What can you say? I'm ready. So, if you're ready, hang out. We're here. So, how's everyone doing this evening? Let's see here. I see a bunch of names in here. I don't see anybody in the room yet. I see a bunch of people that are hanging out. What's up? 1046. Crazy Ann's in the house. What's up, Crazy Ann? How you doing? Hello, my friend. How are you doing? Good to see you, Crazy Ann. Bad Kiwi of to town now. Of to town now? Of to town now. What is of to town now, Mad Kiwi, huh? What am I reading here? I'm starting off my thing. What am I reading? Of to town now. Of to town. Is that off to town? What's up, Joe W? Good to see you, man. How you doing, brother? Joe be going to bed soon, but he stuck around to see me. So Lindsay Lou, what's up? How you doing, Lindsay Lou? Good to see you. Mad Kiwi, hi Ann M mate. Lindsay Lou saying hi to Ann. Crazy Ann, everything spicy. Hello, honey. Hey, how you doing, Crazy Ann? Good to see you. Mad Kiwi. Off. Well, then type off. Don't type of. You know, you can remove the comment and correct it and put in of. That way I don't have to. Just giving you some crap this morning. This evening, sorry. Got to get script to keep me going, right? You got some medication. I got you. So. Lindsay Lou is saying, hey to Kiwi. We got 9 people in the room already. How are we all doing? Everybody make sure you hit that thumbs up when you come in here. Share us out so we can make sure we get plenty of folks in here. Mad Kiwi. Jadzia Dax. What's up, Jadzia? How you doing? Now we got this new little thing going on over in the chat now. It's all colorful and it's letting me know that this is live on YouTube. There's a new thing on this where now it looks like we can go live. And not only will we be live on YouTube, but maybe live on Facebook too or something else. I'm not sure, but it's showing that I've got 10 people in here. I think I got like only 3 or 4 people commenting, so it's kind of weird. I don't know exactly what's going on, but it's really weird. So remember, I'm mad. You're not that mad, Kiwi. You're not. I think you're mad as this mad. I don't think you're mad as you're angry mad. I think you're mad as like you're out of your mind mad. What's up, Eric Pollock? How you doing? Saying hi to me and everyone else. How you doing, Eric? Pepper is a Kentucky Living. If you guys have not checked out Pepper is a Kentucky Living, this guy right here, Jeremy, Pepper is a Kentucky Living, check him out, man. Does some great reviews, does some great challenges. Crazy Ann reminding everybody to smash the thumbs up, share us out. We know how it's done. Deidre Baker's in the house. What's up, Deidre Baker? Good to see you, girl. How you doing this evening? Thanks for stopping in. Crazy. Oh, man, the whole screen just jumped. Chelino Sanchez is in the house. What's up, Chelino? Good to see you, man. Good to see you. So how I saw Chelino today. He sent me some pictures. He got to go out with some firefighters today. Got to look like the full garb on, the firefighter helmet and everything else. Had a really good time. Sherry Watson's in the house. What's up, Sherry? Marilyn Monroe packing. How you doing? Good to see you in here. Country Girl 29, how you doing? Good to see you in here. All right. Crazy Ann saying hi to everybody. There you go. Got to cover them all right there. Thank you, bro. Hey, you know what? We're brothers, aren't we? Peppers? Jeremy? Peppers? Pappers? Girl 29, Dieter Baker saying, hey, what's up? So, yeah, it's actually Chelino. I actually took those 2 pictures that you sent me, put them together, and actually posted it on the Everything Spicy Facebook page. You know, I like to randomly post pictures of people that send me stuff. So I posted those so everybody could see. Kind of made a little comment on what you did today or what I thought you did today based on what you told me you did. But hey, Pepper the Crazy, how are you doing, guys? Eric Pollock, great, only here for a short time. Got to work in the AM. Tell me about it, brother. Tell me about it. So good, my tendon came loose from my collarbone. Well, that's not good. That's actually the opposite. You said good. That's actually the opposite of good. That would actually be bad. When your tendon comes loose from your collarbone, that would be bad, not good. So, Crazy Ann, remember to smash the thumbs up, share out the stream. Berg's Corner's here. What's up, Berg's Corner? Berg's Corner, how are you doing? Rots One is here. All right, let's get the phone going here. Let's see if I can refresh this and it'll pop me up. Nope. Oh, there I am. Oh, that's where Crazy Ann shared me out. There we go. All right, so now we got the chat going on the phone. So I can see, when I see all these little emojis you guys put on here, I can't see them on StreamYard because they're all squares and stuff. So, all right, let's go back up here. So, Chelino Sanchez. I'm fine. And you, hey, Rots, Crazy Ann, Deidre, saying hi to GTSU. Where's GTSU? I didn't see him. GTSU, where's GTSU? Don't see him. Great. Jalino Sanchez, Pepper, Deidre Baker. Rots One. Hello, Peppers, Crazy Ann, and Deidre. We got 14 people in the room. Let's share this out and get some more people in here. We can all hang out together. That'd be awesome. You know, I'm wearing a PG Timmy shirt again. I don't know what I was thinking. You know, I worked for a couple hours last night. It's the first time I wore it. I hung it over a thing last night. Wore my regular T-shirt to bed. I thought, you know what? I'll wear it a second time. Just didn't realize it was going to be tonight when I got on here. So, oh, my goodness. Deidre Baker, good to see you. So, yeah, this is really weird. I wish you guys could see this. Maya in Thailand is here. How you doing, my friend? Hello, everything spicy. How are you doing? I'm doing very well, Maya in Thailand. How are you doing? Good to see you. Where did I see Maya earlier today? I saw Maya earlier in one of the rooms Maya was in. I forget which one. She's all over the place, too. So it could have been one of many places that I saw Maya today. Jeff Frederick is in the house. How's it going, Phil? Good, Jeff, man. How you doing, man? Always good to see you, man. Thanks for coming. Thanks for hanging out with us. Let's see. Joe W., my Everything Spicy T-shirt should be here tomorrow. That'll be awesome, dude. When you get when you get your Everything Spicy T-shirt or you get your sticker, send me a picture. You send me a picture. I put it on our Everything Spicy Facebook page. Other people can see it. You're there forever. So it's kind of cool. I like doing that. So, hey, Maya. Hey, Jeff. Hello, everyone from Maya in Thailand. Crazy Ann saying hi to Jeff Frederick. Maya in Thailand saying hello to Crazy Ann. Everybody loves them. A little bit of Crazy Ann. How you doing this evening, Crazy Ann? How is everyone doing? You see, I go on 5 minutes early and I freak everybody out. Now everybody's lost. They don't know where to go. It's like, oh, no, it was there. It was gone. Now it's here. Now it's back. I don't know. So, Maya in Thailand, Jeff Frederick, hey Joe, hey Crazy Ann. All right, so yeah, so tonight I got a topic, right? You know, we do a lot of different things, a lot of different nights. I thought tonight we would cover like three different things, right? We would cover peppers, we would cover hot sauce, and we would cover tincture. So I've got all three out here. Actually, the other one thing I forgot to mention when I did all that was pepper dust, right? So I got a little bit of the Mugglot pepper dust. I mean, a very little. Look how little I got left in there. I mean, it's kind of, I had to stir that up to get anything out of it. But I got a little bit of the pepper dust from the Mugglot level. And we'll be trying to load that tonight, going, kind of talking about that a little bit too. So Levi B is in the house. What's up, Levi B? Good evening, my friends. How you doing? Levi B. Hey, yo, brothers. Cassie's so sassy. What's up, girl? Oh, there's that picture again. Every time I see that girl, I see the same picture. You give me that look, Mr. Patterson. I'm watching you. I'm getting that Mr. Patterson. Like she's looking at me. Yeah, I'm watching you. I'm keeping an eye on you. I get that pic. I can see that every time I put that up on the screen. That's what I see. It's exactly what I see. Deidre Baker saying, Jeff, hi. What's up, man? Uh-oh. Shane rate of one. There you go. Shane Smithson, man. How you doing, brother? Good to see you in here, brother. Hey, we got the Putt-Putt King is in here, man. If you are all about putt-putting, and you should go see the Putt-Putt King because he does no putt-putt on his channel. There is no putt-putting of any kind going on his channel. So if you like putt-putt, don't go see Putt-Putt King because there is no putt-putt going on there. You can go see him. He does other stuff. But there is no putt-putt on Putt-Putt King, just so you know. It's false advertising. Patrick James Forums is here. What's up? How you doing, Patrick James Forums? Good to see you in here. Oh, you got a picture of the Bible there, King James Version. Holy mackerel. And then, of course, he's got the killer whale thing going, too. Which, I mean, you got a split personality, brother. Cassie's so sassy, giving me a heart and a pepper. Oh, Cassie, how you doing? I appreciate it. So, see, and now I got to look over to the screen over here in order to be able to see that. So, hey, Patrick, how you doing? Pepper's Kentucky Living wants to know. Pepper's Kentucky Living saying hi to Cassie. Oh, my goodness. Got a great bunch of channels in here so far. We got some good followers, people that like to check out what we do. We got some great channels like Crazy Ann. We got Maya in Thailand. Shane Smithson, one of the building channels. Peppers of Kentucky Living, who we're just not but a short few weeks ago, hit his 1,000. Cassie, so sassy. Some great, great channels in there. Patrick James Forum's been around for a while. Patrick's Kentucky Living, hey, loving, hi. Hey, there's someone that's going to pop up here in just a second. How you doing, Laura Leah? It's good to see you in here. And hopefully, this means your Wi-Fi is back and we'll get to see a little bit more of you, girl. But if not, you know, they got to get things taken care of there at your apartment and get things straightened out. You know, let them get things straightened out so you can get back to normal. Hopefully, they get that whole flood. You know, you shouldn't, every time it rains, it shouldn't get wet inside your place. Did you say pepper dust? I'm making some myself. I need to make some myself. I got all these peppers and stuff. I just the time, finding the time. I got to not do this in order to make pepper dust is basically what it turns out to be. Laura Lee, hello, sweetie. How are you doing? Crazy Ann wants to know. Joe W., I'm just a follower. I don't know if I want a channel with videos. You know what, Joe? All you do is you make a video of something and you post it. You know, it's really, you know, at the end of the day, no editing. I think that's the biggest problem people have with their first video is they're afraid it's going to be something that nobody likes. Nobody's going to, you know, there's that whole, they may be intimidated by stuff that other people do. Don't be intimidated by what other people do. People that make their first video, it looks like their first video. And if it doesn't look like their first video, it's because they were doing other videos of other stuff before. Make a video of you doing something. Make a video of you mowing the lawn. Make a video of you doing, like, you know, eating something, doing something. So, anyways, Laura Lee, okay, got an ad on my phone, hon. Having serious issues with the Wi-Fi saying I've canceled it when I have it. It's not even been installed yet. Oh, my gosh. Hey, Crazy Ann, love you. What a good bunch of people. Uh-oh, here we go. We got some UK royalty. Yep. And this will be going on. I think it's Saturday. And Laura Leah and the UK Chili Queen are going to be meeting up. We got the UK Chili Queen in the house. Hey, Phil. Hey, everyone. I'm off to bed. It's 3 a.m. But I just wanted to say hi to you all. Thank you, Shen. Thank you for stopping in. Thank you for stopping in and saying hi. It'd be wonderful. It would be wonderful if someday I could get you up here on the panel, Shen. It would be wonderful if even only for 5 minutes. It'd be cool. It'd be very, very cool. Rots One, the Queen, Shane Smith, and saying hi to Chili Queen, Patrick James, Crazy Ann saying hi to the UK Chili Queen. Nice to see you here. Can't wait to meet you, Laura. Exactly. Laura Leah, UK Chili Queen. Patrick Kentucky Living. Hey, Shine. We all call her Shen. I know that's how you spell her name properly. I don't know how it's actually pronounced. Oh, I've heard it pronounced properly. I always remember Shen. I mean, I remember the easy, lazy American way, Shen. That's easy to remember. Computer chick, you have malware on your phone if you're getting ads like there. Okay, Laura Leah. Not sure if I'm going to, unfortunately, it's almost for a train ticket. Oh, no. Levi B, hello, UK Chili Queen. Crazy Ann saying hi to Computer Chick. Computer Chick, if you have an Android, it happens all the time. Okay. Shen is perfect. Okay. Well, again, it's the lazy English American way. Just Shen is real easy and it works for me. Would you want to come up here for a couple of minutes? I know you're probably going to bed. And you said you're going to bed. But just in case, you know, seeing a link on here would, you know, cause you to possibly change your mind. I'll put one up there. So Dieter Baker saying hi to Laura. How you doing? Oh my goodness. Yeah, we got the Computer Chick girl in here. She knows all about stuff. So you and Laura ought to converse. Maybe you can help Laura get her phone problems corrected. I don't know. So, oh my goodness. So the topic of tonight is just going to be the different types of things that we use to burn, whether it be peppers or hot sauce. I brought some nothing real hot that I brought out. The peppers are out here. They're all hot. I did bring, you know, a hot by Sean Satterfield. His really hot tincture. I got that's like super hot. And then I brought something out from Mad Dog 357 that's kind of hot, but not really hot. Nothing that'll mess with your insides. So Computer Chick, Android is not malware. Levi B, hey, Crazy Ann. Laura Leah, the Cobra Roll. What's up, the Cobra Roll? How you doing, man? Hey, if you guys haven't shared this out yet, share this out. Let's get some more people in here. We got 18 people in the room right now. I don't know how many thumbs up we got, but it'd be cool to get some more thumbs up and get the room built up to a good, 30 or 40 people in here when we get going. We have Eileen Velux, the fam. What's up, Eileen Velux, the fam? How you doing? Hey, Spicy, how was your day? My day's good. I saw you a little bit earlier on someone else's panel. I think that was with, maybe it was Mess Hall. It was Mess Hall. I saw you on. How you doing? Good to see you. Oh, my goodness. I think I scared a UK chili queen up asking her to come on, even though if only for a few minutes. But so maybe someday she'll come on. Joe W., I got myself 100 saved for Phil so I can watch him do Mad Dog 3. What? I got to get myself. I said I'm not going to pay for that stuff. I'm not even going to take it out of the fund for what I give to you guys. Again, if someone wants to donate it, I'll do it. I'm going to tell you right now, if you donate it, it's not good. I'm not doing a Roger Chur. I'm not killing myself. I will try it. I will give you my honest review on it. But, I am not going to murder myself with that stuff because there has not been a single instance where I've seen someone do this where the outcomes have been horrific. So Claudia Hernandez is here. How you doing, Claudia Hernandez? You look new. If you're new, subscribe, share it out, hit the thumbs up. Be cool. So Claudia Hernandez still saying hi. Hey. So let's see here. Well, you got the normal people in here. Is that anybody wants to join me? It looks like we're not going to get up to our 30 or plus people in here. Maybe people are looking at something. You know what? Maybe that's it. Maybe I'm not planning ahead. Maybe there are people. Everybody is kind of spread out all over the place right now. So maybe we ought to get into just bring the panel up here, start talking about things. So Peppers, Kentucky, Livin, Shane Smithson, Crazy Ann, anybody want to join me on the panel? Feel free to join me on the panel. Mommy Ann on the go. What's up, Mommy Ann on the go? How are you? So any of you guys want to join me on the panel? That would be awesome. There's Mommy Ann on the go. How you doing, Mommy Ann on the go? Nothing much. Yeah, well, it's, what is it? It's Tuesday night, right? What's going on Tuesday nights, right? Nothing much, right? There's my beautiful friend, Crazy Ann. How you doing, Crazy Ann?
I'm fine. And you?
Well, there, I got to hit my volume so I can actually hear you. I heard you a little bit.
Yeah.
I got you. Just a little bit. Sherry McMillan's in the house. What's up, Sherry? How you doing, girl?
Hey, Sherry, come up.
That didn't take long. Sherry's like, Sherry was probably sitting there right there saying, do I say hi or don't I say hi? If I say hi and Crazy Ann's on there, Crazy Ann's going to be like, all right, Sherry, come on up. Come on up. All that pressure, man. That's just too much pressure. Getting ready for bed, got to work tomorrow. Yeah, tell me about it, Mommy Ann. I'll be getting up at my normal 6:15 in the morning to go to work. But, I'm on here as long as you guys are on here. So, Eileen Bullocks, hey, beautiful, crazy, and sweetie. Wow, look at all those great words all in a row. Hey, beautiful, and crazy.
Hey, love you.
Let's not forget the crazy part in there.
No.
Shane Smithson, search it out my tip jar. Anything you guys donate, keep in mind, we send out stickers. We've sent out peppers to people. We've done free giveaway on shirts. Everything that you guys do, coming back to you.
Fuck it. Sorry.
She is redoing her office. Queen of Cannabis is here. What's up, Queen? How are you doing? Good to see you in here. Happy Tuesday, everyone. Jersey, I believe I. Justin and Christina's RV Van Life is here. What's up, Justin? Christina's RV Van Life. How are you doing?
Hey, Justin and Christine.
There's Queen of Cannabis.
Sherry, Pepper, come up. I am it. Come up.
Happy Monday, Phil. You are right.
Right.
Happy Monday. Hold on. Happy Monday.
Monday. No.
See, you've been hitting the pipe a little too much, Queen of Cannabis. It's Tuesday already. Tom Jasper, what's up, man? How you doing? What's up, Spicy and Crazy Ann? How you doing, brother? Good to see you in here. I want Crazy Ann stickers. The Crazy Ann stickers are in the mail, from what I understand.
Soon. Yeah.
Soon. Okay. So Barnyard Chicken. What's up, Barnyard Chicken? Good to see you in here. Love your dream catcher, Crazy Ann, from Justin and Christina. It's all purple, and I can't tell, but I know.
No, that's not purple.
The dream catcher's not purple?
No, that's blue.
Well, damn you. Now you're see, I think everything's blue. They're telling me everything's purple, and then I think something's purple. It's like, no, that's blue.
No, that's blue.
My office is messed up. Let me get my laptop in my bedroom. All right. Oh, yes, Tuesday, not Monday, unless you're stuck on yesterday or a random Monday. Oh, I'm doing good, Queen. Eileen, what are you doing? That's huge.
It's blue.
Okay, it's blue. Putting it closer doesn't help me.
Yeah.
I say I would love one of your stickers, too. Eileen Velux, the fam. I know someone will put my email address in my chat. One of you guys put the email address in my chat. And all you got to do is send me your address, Eileen, and you'll get a sticker. And if you've got one to send back to me when you get my return address for my sticker going out, you want to send me one back, that'd be great. I send stickers out on my dime. Doesn't cost anybody anything. So, Crazy Ann, Eileen Velux the fam. Go to my channel, man. Click on this. Okay, there you go. Yes, that is blue, Crazy Ann. I could tell that. I'm colorblind, putt-putt. So kiss my behind, putt-putt. No putt in your putt-putt, in your channel, putt-putt. Putt-putt in the putt-putt. TJ Smith's here. What's up, TJ? Hey, everyone. Much love. How you doing, man? Uh-oh. We got the butt crack scratcher in here. I mean, Doughboy scratcher in here. What's up, Doughboy? Yeah, you're over here, aren't you? This is like the 10th time you're doing here, right?
Change your profile picture. Okay.
Yeah, I don't think you can just think of anything, you know, anything better to say than, hey, I'm new. There's my email address. Crazy Ann was nice enough to throw it in the chat. So, Eileen Beluxa family, anybody that doesn't have a Everything Spicy sticker or would like one, there is the email address. Just got to send me your address, and you'll get, oh, geez, now I got notifications all popping up on my phone. It looks like Sherry just got her video posted. I actually did a video today. I haven't posted it yet. I want to go through and kind of make sure I do everything the right way, right? I'm always so excited. I do a video and I get it all edited and I have it the right way. And I don't do the whole thing on YouTube and everything the right way. So I'm going to start trying to not be so excited like a little kid. I'm going to try to get everything in the description like I'm supposed to and do everything like a professional YouTube person that wants to get the maximum effect from their video. No,
I don't know.
I'm working on it. Killdeer Survival, what's up? How you doing, Killdeer? Good to see you. Oh, never mind. Send me anything because I'm new. Ralph. What are we gonna do with you, Ralph? So if Ralph's trucking is hoot hoot or honk honk or whatever it is, what is Doughboy Scratcher? Is that the scratching sound that we do for Doughboy Scratcher? I mean, what noise do we make for Doughboy Scratcher? Is there a noise for Doughboy Scratcher? They're really cool stickers. They are cool stickers. I get mine from Sticker Mule. They do a great job on them. I'm a little kid, LOL. I am a little kid. I'm just like, I got to get my video done. I just can't wait to get out. See, look how cool that is. We'll take that off the screen. See? And it's vinyl. Cool. So if you put it on your vehicle or you put it somewhere outside and the weather gets to it, it's not going to fade. Now, it might fade over time, but a lot of your stickers are like are made on material that fade really quick when sun hits them. So beep, beep. I mean, really? Beep, beep. Is that the best you got is beep, beep for a Doughboy Scratcher? So you went from honk, honk to beep, beep. And what does Doughboy Scratcher beep, beep? I mean, I don't understand the beep, beep. Scratch, scratch, right? Scratch, scratch. Got to be something like that. Crazy Ann, you look at my husband's niece, but she is from Texas. LOL.
I should be from Texas. Yeah. I like it over in the state. Yeah. I'm born in the wrong place. Yeah.
Lindsay Lou, sorry, phone, I'm back. Sorry, phone, I'm back. Are you too? Is someone on here named Phone? So do I sticker mule? Well, here's what I do with sticker mule, because sticker mule, all of these things, scratch my ass. There you go. All these sticker places can be expensive. I was looking at sticker places today, and I was trying to come, you know, do something for some stickers and just have some reserves. So I always seem to run out of my stickers before they have a new deal. And everybody wants a ton for stickers if it's not one of their deals. So I guess next time Sticker Mule does the die cut or whatever, I'm just going to have to get a whole bunch of them. I have to double up on what I ordered. So, oh, got some dude in a ball cap down here says it's Sherry McMillan. I don't know. I'm not too sure I want to let this troll that's down in my basement in here. I can't. It doesn't look like Sherry McMillan. It's not Sherry McMillan's studio. The person's got a ball cap on. It's completely throwing me off. Melanie, the moderator. How are you? Oh, it's got a PG Timmy shirt on, too. We're twins. How you doing, Sherry?
I'm in the kitchen because my office is in a mess. I'm redoing my office.
Gotcha. 7 degrees. You just can't get a night off, can you, Sherry?
No.
Yeah. I feel like that sometimes too. But I come on here, I was kind of feeling low. I was kind of feeling before I came on here, I was kind of feeling low, like, ugh, maybe I just should go to bed, even though I said I was gonna go on at 9:45 or 9:50. Maybe I should just go to bed and forget it. And I know every time I come on here, the people on here are gonna cheer me up. Crazy Ann's gonna cheer me up. You're gonna cheer me up. There's gonna be people on the panel that's gonna cheer me up, get me out of my yucky feeling and make me feel better. It's Crazy Ann just sitting there looking. See that beautiful smile? See, there you go. Yeah, yeah, that'll do it for you right there. So, Melanie, your moderator, saying hello to Jadzia Dax. All you guys, man, everybody that comes in here, man, you guys are committed to coming in here and visiting with me every night. And I'm committed to giving you as much much decent content as humanly possible for me. We got 28 people in the room. I mean, come on. What are you guys doing on a Tuesday? Everybody should be in bed going to work, getting ready for work. You know, I got to get a good night's sleep. You guys, everybody just leave now and go to bed and, you know, get a good night's sleep. No?
What are you talking about? Shut up.
Oh, my gosh. CSN City Girl, what's up? How you doing? Anthony Chalice House is here. How you doing, Anthony?
Hello.
5 a.m. headed to ranch, but still here to hang shoot. Here to hang shoot. Are we hanging shoot? Must be hang out. I mean, he didn't mean shoot, right? He meant hang out. Page for three. What's up? Hello. Guys, you already answered this question for me before. Did you get the buttons yet? I had to do it a special way in the envelope. If you have gotten them, you'll know what I'm talking about. To try to get them out to where they don't charge me as a package, because then they wanted like $4 to shoot these stupid buttons. I'm trying to stay awake, though, and that's not helping. LOL. Sleep, it's only 9:14. Yeah, but Putt-Putt, you need your beauty sleep. Has anybody seen Putt-Putt recently? He needs his beauty sleep. I'm just joking with you, Putt-Putt. How you doing, man? Okay, bye, Phil. You can leave. We're going to stay.
Sorry.
Is my eyes still red?
Are your eyes still red?
What are you doing? Why?
Making chips. I was
making those chips, and I touched my eyes with the gloves.
Sorry.
The eagle has landed. Well, you got to laugh at that. I laughed at my boss the other day. Kato Noodles is in the house. What's up, Kato Noodles? I laughed at my boss the other day because he got two PG Timmy shirts on, Kato Noodles. I laughed at my boss as he's walking to the kitchen to rinse his eyes out because he touched his, from Pepper touched the corner of his eye, and he's got his eye all shut and everything. He's like, ah, damn. And I giggled like a little kid because, we've all done it. You know, if you do this, you've done it 100 times. You know, you stuck your finger in your eye. unless you're like Crazy Ann when she stays away from the spice. Maybe someday she'll get to touch me and then stick it in her eye and it'll be able to burn.
I have touched chili and touched my eyes and it's not good. I eat chili, regular chili.
It is like you put your eyeball under the water faucet and you're still on fire.
Yeah. That's good to know, a space for three, because again, I got a ton more buttons. If anybody wants buttons, I know how to package them. Because when the first time I tried to package something to someone, they kept telling me I had to put padding in there to try to make it the same thickness all the way across your buttons, but they're considered to be an envelope or a letter as opposed to charging me for a package. So the way I shipped them to you guys, it only cost me $1 as opposed to they wanted to charge me $3 or $4 the other way. So Kate was saying hi to Crazy Ann and to Shane. Cookie with Tracy. What's up, Cookie with Tracy? Good to see you in here. Kill deer survival. Then I need to go to bed in case I need to get out. Then I need to go to bed in that case. I need all the help I can get. But it's hard to turn off YouTube. It is sometimes hard to turn off YouTube. I know when I get off of here, I typically will click on and check things out before I go to bed. I don't want to miss anything, right? What's up, Jalen Anthony? How are you doing? Good to see you in here, girl.
Kay Noodles was in pain last night.
Oh, she was. Yeah, but Hot Sauce Junkie Tim was right there by her side, taking care of her and stroking her back and making sure she was okay. Diana Rose Gabbiano, what's up? How you doing? Yeah, got to take care of our ladies, right? If they're in pain. You know, see, that's the whole thing. I would never, as much as I'd like to see my wife try a little bit of something. Grace by God is here. What's up? As much as I'd like to see my wife try a little bit of something, I don't want to see her in pain, you know?
You don't?
I don't. No, I don't want to see her.
I use that to ask.
You know?
Never know about men.
Yeah. Then, of course, it would be all my fault, too, right?
Yeah.
Bring that stuff into the house. Chewy LTD, what's up? Hello, everyone. Put up a like for you. Everything spicy as I am passing through. I have a mod. Have to mod a live stream. All right, man. Thanks for coming in. Oh, God. I guess he was pretty good to me, but, man, he was like a girl. Are you okay? Well, hey, you know, we're guys. We want to make sure you're okay. You could have just laid your belly on the cold kitchen floor. That probably would have felt really good, right? your belly and stick it on the cold. Not that you've got a belly, but I mean, I know your stomach. So, Putt-Putt King, it's like a long time ago. I was cleaning and wearing gloves. I touched my eye, so I went to the doctor. Told me I didn't really have anything in my eye. Thought I should have that though. Yeah, I mean, at the end of the day, yeah, that stuff will burn for a little bit, but it goes away. Sherry knows. Nothing was good about last night. Holy macaroni. Exactly. Well, I'm sure you had the cramps after that. The cramps? Yeah. Now, you're a girl, you know, and I know girls, you know, they don't like to eat all this stuff. Me, personally, I've gotten to the point where I'll eat whatever I've got to before I'm going to do something super hot. And I will eat after I eat something super hot, and I know it's super hot or it has the potential to, you know, mess up my insides. I will eat whatever. I'll take on the extra calories. I don't give a crap so that I don't have to suffer that pain. Killer Whale. So Patrick Jane Forms, change over to Killer Whale. Gemma's Journey. Grace, how you doing? Gemma, good to see you in here. I am sharing out the link again. So if anybody wants to join the panel, by all means. Kay Nunes, but she was up till 5:30 in the morning. I know the feeling, girl. I was up till 7:30 after the Nemesis, so it's Jamie's show. So, yeah, it's not a competition, you know. I apologize for doing it. I was just thinking, why did I just say that, you know? Bottom line is, yeah, those cramps are hellacious. I ain't fooling with you tonight, but had to say, hey. How you doing, Carter's Eats? Good to see you in here. Linda's House of Chill. Oh! What's up, Linda? How you doing, Linda? Good to see you in here, girl. Shane Smith. See, you caught me. You caught me before I ate anything gross, Linda. We're just shouting people out right now as they're coming in. So you caught me before doing anything gross. If you guys don't know, Linda's House of Chill. She's got some great videos, some great content. and also as a part of a network thing she does, as well as the grow team on Friday. So make sure you check out. I leave the whole hot crap to you guys. Well, hey, that chip's pretty dang hot. So, you know, you're moving right along with the rest of us. Linda's out chill, doing fantastic. So no grossness yet. Actually, there's no grossness planned for tonight. See, the clam juice is empty. So it'll only be hotness tonight. Grace by God to open Gemma's journey. Grace is good. So,
hey, right. Gemma's journey.
So do any of my now I got Sherry up here. Do any of my chili head friends want to join me and we talk a little bit about sauces and peppers and tinctures and pepper dust? Come here. Hello, Gemma and Shane. Oh my goodness. See, I don't know how I do. I've dried out. I've cooked my almonds and stuff with pepper dust before and got myself choking, but I never got. But you did touch your eye. You did say you touched your eye, didn't you, Sherry?
I touch my eyeballs.
Yeah, touching the eyeballs is not good. The barnyard chicken, hot and spicy. I know you. Oh my goodness. I'm burping. Oh, I'm burping. If you need to talk, let me know anytime. Okay. Hit the like and share out the stream. Hit the like and share the stream.
Hey, Dave.
Dave, poems and songs. What's up? Stay away from my crazy aunt. I'm watching you.
They're watching me. I'm watching him. Yeah.
Well, I'm watching the two of you.
Okay. This one is Cujo.
Cujo?
Yep. He's the white Chihuahua.
Cujo looks more like it would be a snack for Cujo instead of Cujo.
Yep.
The other one is Lucky. Come here. He's the one that got snake bit.
Well, that doesn't sound very lucky.
No. Come here, Lucky. Come here. On treat. He's the one that got snake bit.
Is he having any ill effects from it?
He kind of just, at first he didn't want to eat right. He was just laying around. They put him on antibiotics and some other medicine. But, I'm doing better.
Yeah.
He's got to go back to the vet tomorrow to make sure.
Gotcha.
He don't like the vet, do you?
So, kisses to Lucky.
You better do, Jeremy.
Yeah. Come on up, Jeremy.
In a minute, he says.
Hurry up so we can put you in the corner.
There you go. Love the doggies.
Thanks, Shane.
Gotta go walk my dog. Angel's gonna stay in the stream, but. Yeah, okay. Hot sauce junkie Tim's here. Let's see.
Spicy.
There's my spicy t-shirt back there.
Yeah, what the hell?
We support each other, man. We support each other. And then there's mine. There we go.
There we go. Spicy.
There you go. we support each other. I've got one from the Hot Damn Show. I've got one now from R5 Adventures. I've got one from you. Sherry, do you have a shirt?
From you? No.
No, do you have a shirt? A Sherry McMillan shirt. You don't have a Sherry McMillan type shirt.
I'm fixing to change mine. I'm fixing to change the designs on mine. I used to, but I didn't like it.
Gemma, we do have giveaways on shirts and stuff. But you know, the best thing to do is go to Teespring. If you go to my last video I did, It's in there. You can get an Everything Spicy shirt starting at $12.99. So I've got mine priced. I am proud just to see someone have my shirt on. Now, there's other things I have on there that are priced differently. But the $12.99 and the $18.99 shirts are priced just a little over their cost, like a little more than a dollar over the cost. Just so you guys, if you want a shirt, you can have a shirt. If you're moving over here until Phil looks like you are dancing for him. Oh, really? Oh, I will do, brother, Everything Spicy.
Take it, Jeremy.
If you get a shirt, Gemma, if you get a shirt, I need a picture of it. I can post it on my Facebook, and we'll put it on here, too, somewhere. Somewhere, somehow. Gemma's Journey Grace got to be careful with watching movies. All right. Hot Sauce Junkie Tim says, hey, Jeremy. Oh, Pepper saying LOL. Oh, my goodness. Right? We can be weird up here sometimes.
No.
Crazy Ann brings out the weird in me.
I'm hot now. I have to take one off.
Yeah. Uh-oh.
Sorry.
There it is. Shane Smithson, Gemma Journey Grace. Shane Smithson is posting my Teespring thing from my account. And make sure you click on the right one. Make sure you click on the one that looks like Crazy Ann. I sent one to Carol Kennard because she sent me my cutting, right? So I sent her one off my own dime, and I must have clicked on the wrong thing because it sent her one that's got this big black rectangle on it with the logo on it, and I don't like the way that looks. And I'm disappointed, and I don't think that's what I ordered for her. I'm gonna try to check it out and try to see if I can't get that fixed. But Eric Garcia, what's up, Eric? How you doing, brother?
Hey, Red.
That's the $12.99 shirt. So yeah.
That's cool.
It is their lesser quality shirt, but if you want a shirt, that's one. You can also go on the same thing, and there's the $18.99, which is a better quality. I got a feeling the one I'm wearing here. I don't know what this is, but it's not the Teespring. Teespring shirt. So
I love these shirts.
Oh, I do too. This nice.
They're high quality t-shirts.
What's up, Melanie? Jerry Berry 48. Wow, I just went to Crazy Ann changing, right?
Of course.
So, Tim, anybody wants to come on here and join me? Again, we're going to talk about some hot sauces, talk about some peppers.
Pepper.
Something. May not. Everything's but, huh? What?
I look today.
I sometimes answer to whistling like a dog. So if you're whistling to the dog, I thought you were talking to me. So
of course you do.
Hey, Red, how you doing? Good to see you in here. How you doing? We joined the stream, but we're in the hot tub. Oh, nice. Nice. I remember when I had a hot tub way back in the day.
Come on, Pepper.
Hello, Crazy Ann. Louis Fuller's in the house. What's up, Louis Fuller? Bill, did you see the box of pods I got? No, I did not. I was on the computer. I don't know. It was a weird day today. I was on the computer, off the computer. I saw a lot and saw nothing. Does that make a lot of sense?
Yeah.
Sherry Ricky Vlogs, how are you doing?
Hi, Sherry R.
If Devin doesn't mind me asking 3M, where does she live? She's in the UK, right?
Yeah.
It's 428 where you're at, right, Crazy Ann?
Yep.
Yep. Great. Thanks. Your day. Everything's spicy. Doing good, Red. My day is doing good. My day is winding down. This is my way of winding down, except we got 33 people in the house. How do we wind down with 33 people in the house? We don't. We keep on going. Good to see everyone in here. Nice shirt. Looks like a lot of peppers. Nice shirt. Looks like a lot of peppers. Holy mackerel. Yeah, I got to get something together for Roman, because Roman gave me that, you know, when he was talking about needed some peppers, I says, well, you know, here's what shipping costs, and then he gives me a $50 super chat and says, make something up for me. I'm like, oh, okay, now I got to figure out what I'm making up for him. So I figure I stick maybe one of those Prometheus chips in there. I might, maybe, I don't know, send him some clam juice. I don't know. Share the stream out. Thank you, Crazy Ann. Crazy Ann, why are you up, girl? I'd be out like a light. I don't know why Crazy Ann is up. I really can't. I have no idea why Crazy Ann is up at this time of the morning. She likes me a little. She likes hanging out on my live streams. I like hanging out on hers and supporting hers too. So I have been with Cab 7 today. I've been giving my love to him. Oh, I got you, man. Cab 7. Now, I'm not exactly sure. I didn't see a SWAT team or a SWAT. I guess he did get spotted. Some trolls gave some false information or something.
He was doing his live, and they somehow doxed his computer, got his cell phone number. They called him, threatened him, said that they were going to have the SWAT come to his house. A few minutes later, everything was on live. A few minutes later, he had a knock on the door. It was the sheriff's department came in. And where he had his computer, you couldn't actually see the police while they were there. But everywhere he went, they were right there watching him.
Oh, that's crazy. You know, and that's happened to Bounty, and that's happened to other people out there too. So,
yep.
So these trolls out there, man, I mean, I hate the day that I hope that never, I mean, you know, the chance of it happening to one of us is slim, but the chance is there. And it seems as if this is only happening to people in the U.S., right?
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, it doesn't seem like this is something where, you know, maybe our police over here are overcautious or something as far as that stuff going up. Keep up with William Turpin. What's up? How you doing? It seems like it's everything I've ever heard. It's a thing in the United States, which really sucks.
Well, from what I was told, it's best if you're a YouTuber and you do a lot of live streams, talk to your police department, sheriff's department, and let them know that you are a YouTuber. That way they can kind of get the heads up. So if someone does call, no one gets hurt.
Yeah.
But they still have to go to your house and make sure everything's okay.
Well, that was the thing with him. He said he had let his local law enforcement know that he is a YouTuber and everything else. And he says he thinks it helped a little.
Yeah.
You know? And that's scary. That is scary that, you know, someone could actually, the police, you know, they would listen. And, you know, and the sad part about it is there's no repercussion for the trolls. Because at the end of the day, you know, this is thousands of dollars when they send SWAT or whatever to your house, right?
Yeah.
That costs, you know, the government a lot of money whenever they do that. And there's no repercussions for these people. So they can just keep doing it and doing it and doing it.
The police department and the sheriff's department stuff, SWAT and stuff, they don't have time to, you know, go and check on crap that's not something actually going on.
Right.
That's taking a lot of the taxpayers' money. They got to realize that. But they have to do their job, too. So.
Yeah, someone's saying what they saw was the state police that came, Jeff Frederick said. So, scrapping together, how you doing, man? Yeah, I don't know, man. It's just, you know, it'd be funny if that ever happened here. I think if it ever happened here, my wife would be like, all right, we're shutting this down. We're not doing it anymore. You know, you find something else to do with your time. I think that's exactly how she would react initially if that ever happened. And, you know, again, I'm sure that thought goes through the YouTuber's mind, like Cab7 or Bounty or whatnot. When that happens to you, you're like, do I really want to go through this to continue to do this? But I would think once you actually got swatted or got raided, then I would think that, you know, then it wouldn't happen again, you know. The chances are that they get the police or whatever, then it would be that, you know, the message is out there that it wouldn't happen again. But I don't know. That's just craziness, man. Craziness. Baptist Kentucky Living, what are you waiting for? I jumped out and get up here. Now.
Yeah.
So I've got a little bit of food on my stomach. What I wanted to talk about with the peppers and stuff is what people actually think is the hottest, you know. My inclination, I don't know what Sherry's is. It really depends on what you get. For me, my Reapers have been amongst the hottest things that I've done as far as heat goes, right? Eating multiple Reapers obviously just makes it twice as hot. You know, recently I've had a couple of Reapers that, you know, lit me up with just one Reaper. But I've also had some very hot tincture. You know, again, I brought my Sean Satterfield tincture out here, and he's like a Walter White of the chemists with this stuff. Hey, crew, I just emceed my second ever pepper eating contest for massive crowd. Came over after these jams, and we finished it. The first contest was epic. Cool. Death Shots and this are probably the two hottest tinctures I ever had. And again, Sean Satterfield has got like beakers and everything. You know, most people just put it in a jar, peppers and whatnot, and do it the normal, I guess, lazy way. But apparently he's got this whole setup and whatnot, like he cooks meth or something, where he's actually making this tincture and makes it pretty dang hot. This was one that I made a mistake, and I filled a proper top and an entire dropper and didn't have any clue how hot it was. And I put that entire thing in my mouth. And I would say that was probably the hottest thing I ever did, because my whole mouth was on fire, my throat was on fire, everything on my face, my sweat glands, my eyes were running, my nose was running. I was eating ice cream, and the ice cream wasn't helping. Everything I was doing, nothing was helping. So, nope, never, ever I've touched tinctures. Nope, I'm done. Well, again, the Dragon Jewel is pretty hot too, but I've never had the Dragon Jewel. The other day, I ate two hots. Night and day difference in heat. So not all peppers are the same and have the same heat. That is true. Again, I sat here the other night, had two Reapers, two completely different heat levels from those two different peppers. So, hey, everything spicy, hollows, all is well. Oh, Supernatural Lost Adventures. Wow, why can't I speak tonight, man? I can't read. I can't speak. Maybe I'm trying to do it all too quick. What's up, Mama Q? How you doing, Mama Q?
Good. Hey, Mama Q.
Is StreamYard free software keen to join the sweet crew at some stage? Yes, StreamYard is free. This is not costing me a thing. Now, of course, you'll see StreamYard, where Crazy Ann is sitting. You'll see Powered by StreamYard because I'm not paying for it. There's going to be stuff on here. I can't put anything additional on here, but when you do pay for it, you can have your logo up here. You can do different things with it. Not a lot of different things. So, you know, a lot of people don't think that with what they allow you to do for the extra $20 a month, that it's actually worth it. But John Sincere is hot, right? The other one that's hot, too, is the one by Michael Tan. Michael Tan, Fire Drops. Are almost as hot as Sean Satterfield. Michael Tan stuff. That stuff is hot. Prepping for Nemesis Bar this weekend. Everything's spicy. Very good. Supernatural Lost Adventures. Do you have a time when you're going to do that Supernatural Lost Adventures? Because I can go to my phone right now and tell Siri to remind me. Crystal, good day from Western Australia, Tim. Crazy Ann reminded everybody, smash the button, share out the stream.
Smash it. Share it. Yeah.
So I'm just going to take a little of this just because. And it's going to be very little because this is the hottest stuff.
Hey.
I tell you, man, I forget, and then every time I do that, how hot that is.
Yeah, you're hot.
I mean, that's probably the equivalency of 4 or 5 drops, and that little bit that I put in my mouth. Oh my gosh! Did you get the S Yard update? No. I think Crazy Ann's got the StreamYard update, don't you? Yeah.
Yep.
You know what? I've considered it. I've considered it, now that I'm monetized and everything else, I can put some of the money that I get from YouTube towards that. But that's also an extra t-shirt I can give away every month too. Smash it, bash it, mash it. Take it to the bank. Thank you, Papa.
Share a link.
Bill, you got to gargle that. Like, not that, bro. Not Sean Saturday. I made that mistake already, brother. I made that mistake already. One time is enough. That's hot. World champion.
Share the link. Hey. Put out the link. No.
Well, it won't kill you, Matt Kiwi. It sure burns good, though. And Sherry decided she was going to get up and clean the kitchen. It's just not interesting enough.
But I'm still here.
Yep. So what we got to do is hopefully Faith comes on later tonight. And we hopefully Faith has left something. What are you doing?
I asked 4 or 5 times to share a link out. StreamYard, you know.
Yeah.
Share it out.
Share it out. Me?
I can do it.
Well, you want me to share
your StreamYard link to Pepper so he can get up?
Oh, that's what you're talking about. Sorry. I don't know what the hell you're talking about.
What have you been drinking today?
I don't know.
Men.
I'm not a small man. Holy mackerel.
Yeah.
The burn was getting to me. Maybe that was what it is. I'll blame it on the burn.
You blame it on the burn.
Blame it on the burn.
Mm-hmm.
But I told Faith if she comes back on here that anything she leaves out on her counter, she's got to take a tablespoon of it and eat it for the camera. So, maybe I shouldn't have ever told her that. Because now she'll clean up her counters before she comes on. Pappers. Sorry to wake you up, man. We're doing good, Diana. How are you? Then we got the Mad Banana. What's up, Mad Banana?
Hey, Max. Mad Max. No, Mac Evie. Mad Max.
What is this?
I'm driving.
You are?
Driving.
Yep, that would be driving.
It's raining.
Driving.
Hi, Pepper.
Hey, what's up?
I think she's in the kitchen.
Shit, weather.
I need to go. Y'all come with me. I'm gonna go get a box.
A box.
Y'all can walk. Y'all can walk with me. Y'all can walk with me.
I'm
not walking anywhere. I'm staying right here.
Bull crap. You are there. You just
I've got very, very tender taste buds, and I don't want to ruin them because we've got some really tasty food over here in New Zealand.
Oh, yeah?
No.
I'd love to try some stuff in some of the different countries. Even when we come on cruises, we wind up in places where typically you're just going to get tourist type food. You never get anything that is, and where you'd actually get to taste something cool.
Yeah, I know, but the thing is with hot food, like peas and curries and all that sort of thing, you don't need to mask the food that you're actually making it from.
What's a big dropper there?
Big one.
Who's that?
Tone Ranger.
Tone Ranger?
It's either his blueberry or blackberry ghost tincture.
E-commerce, what's up, man? How you doing?
They both got the same aroma to it.
Do they?
Yep.
Well, e-commerce is coming here blowing it up.
Nope. Bye.
What is the play button beside all this now?
Right. Well, that's I think that's for YouTube. So when I get, when I logged on here, it asked me if I wanted to do multiple streams. So I'm thinking what it's I think now maybe you can go live on YouTube and like Facebook at the same time.
Yeah.
I mean that would be something where if I that would be something.
I don't want to.
But I think most everybody that's seeing me on YouTube is seeing me on Facebook. Now that might be great.
I don't want all my family to see this. No.
Well, see, I have an Everything Spicy account, and then I have my own, you know, personal account. But my own personal account, my Chili Head friends on it anyway. So I started accepting Chili Head friends long before I did an Everything Spicy Facebook page. So,
y'all are dancing.
Yeah, I thought I'd try this really hot. Hot sauce that I got, this stuff called spontaneous combustion, but since the maker of spontaneous combustion is nowhere to be found.
I don't know. I can't get none of that.
No?
No.
Maybe.
Can't find it. Every time I go to the store, it's out.
I was going to get the spoon out, and I was going to spoon.
You can just down that. You can drink it. Chug.
We'll just finish it off.
Yes. One giant chug. There we go. That's what I'm talking about.
Chug.
Yeah. Good stuff there.
Yeah, that is good stuff. All right. Well, I got this on the pre-buy, so it's supposed to automatically keep coming to the house every time I run out of one.
There you go.
Just joking, Sherry. Nameless teacher, what's up? How you doing, man? Levi B, Turkey Lake TV, what's up?
Hey, Turkey Lake. Hey,
spicy.
Oh, yes, sir.
I too can make a sauce with yogurt and tomatoes and no chilies and say it's the hottest thing since sliced bread.
Well, this is hot. This has got peppers and stuff in it. I didn't make it.
That's hot.
It is hot. It's not, you know.
It's not overpowering.
It's hot enough where, you know, that
non-chili. And it's blended. Blended with cucumber and yogurt.
Nope. Your other sauce is hotter than that one.
Yeah.
And I don't know how to get a hold of that one. Is that one all gone?
Yeah, I've already got it done.
And you sold them all?
No.
Oh.
What you talking about, Phil?
I don't know.
I'm stacked up on hot sauce. Everybody order. I got plenty.
I can't keep track of everything you do, woman. Warrior for Christ, what's up? Hello, Spicy and Spicy Gang. How you doing, Warrior?
I think both of them need to be marketed. I think they need to be in stores.
Yep. She'd definitely have to do it at a much larger quantity. So
yeah.
Trying to upload them much at the same time, almost impossible. Right?
They're good.
Yeah, that's good. Now, another one that I kind of liked about, well, see, this one I kind of like more the novelty of it. They're good tasting sauces, but they're not really super hot. Any of you guys have seen this before?
Yeah.
The General's hot sauce actually looks like a grenade.
Yeah, I've got an order for you.
Got the top of this off.
Yeah.
It looks, you know, it's got a plastic handle. Looks like a grenade. They all come with a dog tag on them. I know I'm keeping it small here. Maybe I should enlarge this, but not.
Yeah, I know. What's up, Tim? My bro there too.
Saying hi to Jeremy.
That's my bro there too.
I guess I should enlarge this here, right?
There we go. Yeah, we got to see us up close here. See that pool? Oh, yeah. Consistency's good. Gosh. Uh-oh.
Now, this is their one with just Louisiana cayenne peppers, garlic, and salt. So, not even really hot, but it's got a really good flavor to it. None of their sauces are like super hot, like some of the stuff that we get or like. But it's got a really good flavor.
That's the main thing.
Yeah, and flavor, sauce was flavor and heat, and tastes better. But that's got a good flavor to it too. So that would be something that, you know, again, you don't have to be a chili head to enjoy it. So
right.
I just don't understand.
No,
I don't understand. I don't understand.
Name of T-shirt wearer.
What do you put these hot sauces on other than a teaspoon and then down it?
Everything. Now, see this, when we do it this way, you know what you're tasting. You know, you taste the different different like ingredients and stuff. When you put it on food, it spices it up. So we pretty much put it on everything. You know, there are people that put it on eggs. There are people that put it on, you know, whatever meal they happen to eat. Some people will put hot sauces and barbecue sauces and things like that on their burgers, on their brats, on their dogs.
Ice cream.
Just a dab.
Yeah.
Just a dab.
Yeah, I've got blueberry hellfire that I put on regular vanilla ice cream.
Yeah, I understand that side, but I just don't understand you guys just a teaspoon or glugging it down and all that. It's just, no.
Well, yeah, it's to kind of be able to describe what the sauce tastes like.
Yeah, you get the aroma of it, see what all ingredients you can smell, you know, you can taste it a lot better off the spoon than you can on food. I mean, it's just, you know, you get like Phil said, you get a better idea of the flavor and the heat, you know.
So, yeah, this is a funny thing, because I used to live in England, and I traveled through Europe and all that, and did a lot of traveling. And you always got the curries and spices and the hot sauces and that in third world countries. So it basically killed off all the bacteria of the almost rotten meat that you're putting in the food. That was the whole point of it, if you know what I mean.
I have not seen you in this video, Turkey. Well, if that's their point, I don't know if that's the point of what they do it on there, to kill the rotten meat.
Well, it kills the bacteria, anyway. It kills... Or it just masks the flavor of the meat going off. It could be
there to mask the flavor of something that's, obviously they don't have refrigeration and thing in a lot of these countries like we do here in the States, or they do in most countries where, you know, you put your meat in refrigerate stuff and everything else.
Thank you, Warrior.
Private chat, Jeremy.
Yeah, I just saw that pop up in the private chat. I'm like, what is that?
I don't know what that.
Which one?
The
email?
Not the email.
Oh.
Nikki Pink, what's up?
I'm not sure.
My other address.
I'm sending out stickers. Yeah.
Okay.
But I think a lot of us kind of, in some way, shape, or form, are modeling what we do after Johnny Scoble, right? Johnny Scoble's a guy with, 50,000 plus followers or whatever. You know, he does reviews on all these different sauces and whatnot. And again, that's how you really get a good sense, whether it be doing a tincture straight. Your tincture design, you can put those on stuff too. I actually took my death shots. And when my wife was making homemade preserves, she was making jelly. I added death shots to make a strawberry jelly to make a spicy strawberry jelly.
That'd be nice.
What did I miss?
The private shot.
Yeah. Okay.
Hi, Nikki.
Thank you.
Well, that's the thing, too, when I'm cooking a good curry. And I put a wee bit too much chili in to tone it down a bit. I throw sugar at it.
Hey, Nikki.
And that tones it down.
Yeah.
John is graphics. How are you doing?
Hey, Sean does graphic.
But anyway, guys, I got to go and finish doing the housework for my lovely wife, and I've got to put a roast chicken on and make it look all tickety-boo because the weather is miserable, and I've got to make her feel happy.
Gotcha. Since you're doing the housework, is she going to mow the lawn for you?
No, I did. I've done that already.
Oh, okay.
In between the rainy stuff.
Oh, I gotcha. All right, well, thank you, Matt Kiwi.
See you later, Kiwi.
What's your first name?
Craig.
Great. What is it?
Craig.
Great.
C-R-A-I-G. Craig.
Oh, Craig. Gotcha.
All right. I just like to know. So.
And you're Jeff.
I'm Phil.
Phil.
Right.
Yeah, so. Cool, man.
No worries, folks. See ya, Ann.
See ya,
Sherry.
See ya,
Peppers.
See ya, man.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye, man.
Doing good, Shauna's graphics. So are you done now, Sherry?
No.
No.
I'll find something else to do here in a minute.
Well, yeah. There's always something else to do, right?
Yeah.
That's what it is around here.
Always
something else to do. JDS, what's up, brother? How you doing?
JDS.
What's up,
What's up, Diana? Hello, everybody.
Now, you know what this is, right?
Paper dust.
Oh.
Now, this is what is on Sherry's chips, because this is super hot. This is not his diluted stuff. This is his hottest stuff. I don't know if yours is straight Reapers or just straight super hots, but it should be the same color. Do you have some? The same color? Yeah. Yeah, it looks like the same color.
I love that. Man, that color is awesome, though.
Pure Carolina Reaper powder.
Yeah, I don't know if it's pure Carolina Reaper. He said it's super hot, but
there you go. Sweet. Oh, what's up? Oh, what's up? Woo. Uh-oh. Dang, here we go. Sweet.
Here you go, Bill.
Oh, there you go. So, I already did mine, so it looks like it's a similar color, yeah.
Really fine powder.
Yeah, it is. He does a good job grinding it up.
Yes.
Now, see, what I like to do with this, this is where I was doing my bagels with cream cheese and then sprinkling this on top of it. It would make it just spicy enough to, but yet tolerable with the cream cheese and stuff on there.
Well, I cannot cook this in the house.
No?
No. The aroma is so bad, it will take your breath.
Well, we were joking.
We took and got a toaster oven, got several of them, and took them out on the back patio and cooked them, brought them back in the house, and took them out and put them in the bags.
Dang.
Because the aroma will knock you out.
Yeah, see, what I wound up doing when I was doing the almonds, I was doing Phil's nuts.
Yeah.
I basically wound up, at the end of the day, cooking the nuts and everything, and then I would put the pepper dust in the final thing of brown sugar and cinnamon, and not cook the pepper dust on the nuts anymore, because cooking the pepper dust on the nuts was fumigating the house.
I know what you mean. We had doors open, windows open, and I cook the chip in the oven, But when I get ready to do the seasoning, you know, the spices on the actual outside of the chip, I do it in the toaster oven outside.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Because Brittany Duck. It's all Brittany
Duck. Right.
What are you giggling about?
I don't know.
You don't know. Okay. God loves me. What's up? How you doing? God loves me. Good to see you in here.
Just being silly, Phil.
Hey.
Just being silly. I don't know.
I'm always yeah.
Talking about Phil's spicy nuts.
Yeah.
Hey, Phil, I'm working on I got somebody working on a website for me.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
If you want to sell your nuts. Let me rephrase that.
There's a 1-800 number for that.
You know, I can peddle my own nuts. Thank you.
Getting hotter.
I can send them to you, and they can make their order through you.
Oh my god!
I still gotta make that video. I still gotta make the.
Remember that. Then we all want to sell your nuts.
What's up, babe? How you doing, man?
Go to Phil.
Go to Phil's website.
I put them in this little bag. They're right on there. All right on there is Phil's nuts.
Yeah, they are in the bag, yeah.
They're in a bag, ain't they?
Yep. They're in a bag.
In a nut sack?
My nuts are in a bag, yep.
My chips are in a bag like this.
Nice.
It's heat sealed. So when you get it, you got your chips in it.
Yeah.
Fire will come out of the bag. You got to.
Just when you open it, don't be right over it. Move it away from you.
You know, Papa, yes, I sell my nuts. I sell my nuts to the highest bidder.
How much?
Now,
my brother,
for the ones that do not know that ordered all those chips,
mm-hmm.
there is a little thing here you can grab a hold of and pull. Okay, it'll open the bag this way.
Okay, all crazy. No,
have you shipped any yet, Sherry?
Huh?
You shipped any chips yet?
Yes. I've shipped yours, Peppers, Rogers. Oh, God. It was a big shipment went out today, okay? 100 bags of them suckers was made.
100 bags?
100 bags.
Good Lord.
Oh, you got 100 orders?
Yes.
Holy stinkies.
Dang. I was like,
there you go.
I need to think.
Well, how were they marketed that you got 100 orders?
But see, I'm not making anything off of the chips.
Yeah, I know. You're just charging for shipping.
Yeah, I'm just, you know, I'm just doing this as a challenge for everybody. Mm-hmm. And my husband said,
you order like 90 bags of them or something?
No. No, it was a lot of YouTubers.
Really?
I told them to be waiting on videos. I'm gonna be watching. But Pepper's got a little something extra.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
A little extra love from Sherry. So is there going to be a hashtag? That when we do this, we have to have that hashtag in our video so that they all wind up being able to be looked up in the same place.
Yes. Hashtag another one bites the dust.
Ah.
That's nice.
That way, we all know who it is.
Yep.
Hmm.
But don't be surprised if I come on your video. If you do the video, you do the challenge, I say, okay, expect something in the mail.
That's if you complete it, right?
If you complete it.
My thought watching you do it is that there's not going to be a lot to complete it.
Well, what Phil,
what could it be?
I'm going to tell you, last night I sat in front of the computer. I ate those 12 chips. I was in pain.
I believe you.
The stomach cramps were the worst.
Oh my gosh.
I tried getting in the bathtub thinking that would help. Guess what? It didn't help.
Yeah, this Flynn kind of. Hello.
What the hell?
Everything.
What's up, Teresa? How are you doing?
Hi, Teresa.
Hey, Teresa. Hey, Faith.
Jerry, what about the
Surprise? There's no challenge on that.
You want me to do something or no?
Yeah, you can.
Okay.
Because nobody has ordered those.
No, Pamela? Crystal? Wow.
Two videos now. Yeah.
So you'll be the first one on that.
That's why I was wanting to ask you. I didn't know.
Yeah.
You want to? Yeah, okay. So two videos. All right. Awesome.
But I will be sending something out, a little extra for you and Phil. After I get this done, it's a new hot sauce.
Hold on. Putt-putt. I don't think our jalapeno ones will put you in the bathtub, dude.
No.
That's what he was talking about. You'll be all right. You'll be all right with, you, if you want to buy them, you'll be all right with them.
It's the other ones. Just be careful.
I already know what's going to happen to me then.
Don't stick it in your eyes.
Maybe that's the challenge. You're supposed to rub your finger on the peppers with both fingers and then rub them in your eyes.
The phone had rung and my eyes were itching and I grabbed it. And
I had the gloves on and I'm like, oh God,
taking them off and trying to answer the phone. And it was my brother on video call. He seen my eyes. They looked like they were swelled. So it was bad.
It was bad. Patches and Potholes. What's up, Patches and Potholes? How are you?
Hello, hello.
Shoot, I've been sprayed once. That's all I want ever in my eyes again. So.
Yeah, it seems like no matter what I do, I'll wind up with something in my eyes.
Well, when was the last time I did it? It was the I know what it was. It was the dark CCN.
That you got in your eye?
Yeah, I got it in my eye on the video. I hate that. You're doing something, you're right in the middle of a channel, you get something in your eye, just like, oh, I'm losing. I don't want to do it no more. But then you're like, oh, wipe it out, and you're okay, it's gone. Then you're it made me mad for a little bit.
I did that on the burn time on my Death Nut 2.0. So I was on the burn time with my mouth. I picked up the paper towel off the counter.
Yes.
Had some nut powder on it. Yeah, I said nut powder. Yeah.
Well, I know, yeah.
Nut powder, nut.
Nut powder is bad for you.
You really love those nuts of yours. Yeah.
Yeah. Everybody loves my nuts. I sent my nuts to Roger, and Roger's had my nuts in his mouth. I sent my nuts to Tim, and Tim's had my nuts in his mouth.
Oh.
I sent my nuts to Harmony, and Harmony's had my nuts. So I'm sharing my nuts with plenty of YouTubers.
Only one.
I didn't get the nuts. So.
Well, this was before Sherry.
Only men.
Again, this was before Sherry's time, so maybe I'll spice up my nuts again and send you some spicy nuts there, Sherry.
All right.
Kimmy the doll, what's up?
Hurry up, R5. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Sherry's aunt trying to get me on some. Huh? Sherry's aunt.
Indiana Zaporte, how are you doing,
Sparkle? What about my friends and nuts now? Good God, my.
I have to say, now see, when I made them, I didn't make them challenge hot. I mean, they would be challenge hot to the normal person, but I made them where you could actually enjoy them. There was enough Carolina Reaper powder and whatnot on them where you could actually sit there and eat a handful of them, not much more than a handful, and you could actually enjoy them. Because you got brown sugar and cinnamon on them, so, and they were almonds, so.
Have you tried them with pecans?
No.
Hmm. Right there. That's a good idea.
Hmm.
Hmm. Hmm. I love pecans.
Put a little bit of sugar, a little bit of honey.
Yes. Yes.
Reaper powder.
Oh, JDS.
Uh oh.
JDS talking to the other JDS? What's he talking to?
I don't know. It's two JDS in there, so yeah. I don't know.
There's a garage door. I think it's not gonna be too hot for me. Well, I think, you know what, I think the way I make them, I think, you know, you probably could have, you know, two or three to someone that isn't a chili, you could probably have two or three, but then would be done. But I think like a normal person, like Roger, I gave them to Roger. Of course, Roger treated them like they weren't hot at all. Tim enjoyed them, but again, they weren't challenge hot. They were just, here's something I'm making. I got some Carolina Reaper stuff on them, and I wasn't trying to make them challenge hot. So.
This is the jalapeno ranch. I'll kind of let you guys see. Well, kind of hard to see it in the plastic.
Right?
Yeah, with the ranch. And it has the jalapenos.
Well, good Lord.
Dried jalapenos. Grounded. Very, very fine. So.
Cherry Berry, how long ago did you send your mailing address? I mean, the last time I sent stickers out was about a week ago. So if you haven't. Do me a favor, Cherry Berry, because again, I get stuff in every direction. Go to my email address again and send me your address, and I will send you a sticker. I'm more than happy. I miss people, Cherry Berry. I miss people all the time. I had a guy give me, I had a Chileno Sanchez gave me $8 for some peppers.
That's a cool pepper.
I completely forgot about him for a week and a half. So sweet. I see you, Cherry. You going to eat that?
I just picked it off the plant.
Oh, I thought you were going to stick it in your eye. No? Just joking.
What's up, Bounty?
Hi, Bounty.
What's up, Bounty? How you doing, man?
Uh-oh.
How you doing, man? Good to see you, man. Thanks for stopping in. What kind of pepper was that?
It's floral.
Is that ghost?
Was it a ghost?
Mm-hmm.
It looks like it was floral.
The floral?
Yes.
Oh, God.
You see the look on her face?
I can't stand a floral.
Don't that floral taste is ruined to burn? I hate it.
Well, at the beginning for me, like my Katie's were kind of floral. It was the only thing I had. I didn't have any Reapers yet, so the Katie's were the first thing that were hot peppers that I could do. So I tolerated the floral. But as soon as I was eating Reapers, when I went back to a Katie's, that made the Katie seem twice.
Good night, Bounty. Good night, Bounty. Good night, dude.
Good night, Bounty. Have a good night, man.
Yep. I hate floral. I hate it.
See, we've had R5 around just long enough to where she hates floral, too.
I don't like them. But I found out they don't taste floral if you take the seed and the placenta out of them.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Huh. So I think the floral comes from the inside of the pepper.
Yeah. I've got to get one of Tim's red shirts. I like them red ones. PG Timmy, PG Timmy. Okay. You okay?
Two, two, two.
Yep. Just going down the wrong way. That was a little floral.
There you go. Yes, but we had a Sherry had a spoonful of perfume. Nasty smelling perfume though.
There's some free advertising. There you go. Now Tim, you have got hashtag PG Timmy on every one of your videos, right? I mean, the fact, if you don't, I mean, if people see this and they do hashtag PG Timmy, it should bring them right to you.
Yep.
Venus Eats, what's up? How you doing, Venus Eats? Good to see you in here.
Hey, Venus.
And what am I, chopped liver?
You're the male model for it.
I'm the male model.
You're the male model for it.
I want not to be for it.
It's like Price is Right now. Price is Right now has got male models.
Oh, does it now?
Yeah. Yeah, they got male models now. Thanks, Tom, for more. Tincture. I can't say it.
Tell you, even that little orange pepper was hot. That's a slimmer, though. Slimmer is typically hot.
It made my nose run.
Yep, got mine running.
It's not a bad thing. I like my nose running. No.
Jollers in the
Rob.
Jollar.
Hey, Rob.
There he is, Rob. Woo-wee.
And then there's Muglock.
Oh my gosh, man. Rob sending me some pepper. He showed it in the video. Them things are humongous. What's up, Brad?
Hey, Brad. I just showed off your Reaper powder.
Yeah.
Woo. I see YouTube in the background.
Yeah, she's got a pillowcase that she puts over that thing now in the back.
Oh, okay.
She ordered me a YouTube sticker. A little bit bigger than my stickers to put back here on my logo.
Mm-hmm. I still got to order some stickers.
But just one. Boy, that pepper was hot. I thought I was going to eat one that wasn't going to be that hot. It was hot.
Surprise.
Surprise.
I got some new stickers that'll be coming out. So everybody's address I have, you'll be getting a new sticker.
Awesome.
Pepper burp. Oh, I'll follow.
Bread. What?
Brian, your pepper powder made me take my toaster oven outside and had to cook it with the powder on out, you know, on the chips. Cook the chips inside, but I had to cook the powder on them outside. The smell.
Uh-oh. Faith just burned her tongue.
Faith,
be
what?
Careful. Be uh-huh. careful. Be careful.
On her taco.
Oh, Lord. Thanks, Terry.
Brother, back on there.
Now you bite your tongue on a taco. The moon's so hot.
I can't do it. I'm gonna die. I'm gonna die.
Oh my goodness. Holy mackerel. Shane Taco Tuesday. Oh my God. I don't know. It's something just hit me. I was like, holy crap, I just had a laugh.
I tried out my new air fryer. It works pretty good. I ate that pepper. My nose running. Phil's nose running.
Yep. Wow. Sometimes something just catches you funny, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm. Now you say about oopsie, oops, oops.
Where did you disappear off to, Ann? Oh, I had to get some water. Mm-hmm. I only brought one little small bottle down here.
Oh man.
Jim's got a message for you, Sherry.
I'll wash them. I can't stand a dirty dish. Now
you come to my house too, because my kids have been dirtying them up like the dickens since my wife's been gone.
Oh, cool. Yeah. I love that stuff.
Now I'm letting everybody know I'm not drinking alcohol.
Apple cider.
Yep.
Moonshine. Just kidding. I'm kidding.
Moonshine. It's not.
Moonshine.
Oh, Tim, I don't know, man. It's Tone Rangers, the blueberry or the blackberry ghost. I don't know which one it is. Well, they both got the same aroma to it. They got the same aroma. But that's the one I got.
GG. Ann looks tired.
Not.
Wake not up.
Who? I don't know.
Cherry berry. What happened?
I just read cherry berry. Yeah.
Good night, warrior.
Good night, warrior.
Good night, warrior. Ask him.
Oh, it has something to do with networking. Wait. There.
He's subscribing to you. That just using another word in the chat.
What are you doing?
I'll do it like 5 minutes. Oh, gosh.
What the hell are you doing, Brad?
He's licking the screen.
He's a screen licker.
He's licking you.
Glass licker.
You screen licker. Screen licker.
You realize I'm on a cell phone and every one of your pictures is the size of a pinky fingernail.
And? I see peppers.
Yeah, you see where they're at? Let me turn around.
In the garage.
Yeah.
On a trailer.
I had to clean my garage. Wow. I had to clean my garage so I can put them all in here. And they are loaded to the gills, too.
Man.
Look at some. I'm going to pull this little tiny plant right here. Look at the size of these things.
Good grief.
Let me put it down somewhat so you can see my hand touching them. That sounded weird.
Yeah, it did.
Yeah.
Anywho, they're good size. I mean, that's just four of them in a cluster.
Wow.
That's a little plant.
Yeah, just some seeds that started not long ago, but every one of these are just loaded. I couldn't let that happen.
That's the reason I got all mine in the garage.
No, okay, my question is, all right, so if the peppers don't ripen, you should still be able to pluck them off, chop them up, and make some kind of dust, right?
Yeah, I do the green ones just the same as I do the ripe ones.
Right. It's still going to make hot pepper dust. That's what I figured.
I mean,
that's why I started plucking some of the green ones off.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, they're still hot. Don't get that wrong.
Oh, yeah. I know that for sure.
I got that little lip in the garage and trying to push this trailer in and out, you know, knock peppers off. So I had a green one fall off and I took a chomp on it earlier and I was like, oh, that one was warm.
Yep.
And you're missing a cap.
What?
Your cap. Your hat.
You need a cap?
I think that's what she's talking about. Yeah.
Me too. What color? What color, Laura?
Yeah, I sent everybody's chips out yesterday, and I got I got today. Well, tomorrow.
Hey, Phil. Do you hear Michaela in the background?
No.
You don't.
Mm-hmm.
Is that excuse you?
Camo.
That's her. Listen, she'll sing. Listen.
Hey, Sean and Casey, how are you doing? Well, we've had some hot peppers, we've had some tincture, we've had some hot sauce. I just didn't bring any raw eggs down here.
Oh, that's good.
Oh.
Max Air 420, what's up? How you doing, man?
This is getting weird.
Phil, what'd you do with your plants yet? You leaving them outside till the frost kills them?
Rebel.
Sorry. So you're saying I should have them inside now?
Yeah.
Well, what's the temperature at your house?
Well, it hasn't gotten down to the 30s yet.
It's 46 here, and they're in the garage. Yeah.
Well, I better get mine in then. All right. Well, I'll have to do that on Friday. I hope they'll make it a few more days.
Sunday, we get down to 48.
Well, I know Saturday at my house, it's going to get down to 30. So I'm going to assume Michigan's going to be just as cold, which means it'll kill everything that is outside.
But I can't bring all my peppers into my basement.
You could. You'll have to move your chair you're sitting on.
I have to move the entire damn room for all the peppers because they're all big and bushy now.
Well, so are mine. Mine are too. I'm not bringing all of them in. Obviously, I hand selected a few. And the rest of them are just going to have to die.
Yeah, I'm going to have ones that are going to die this year. Sure. I ain't bringing the 45 peppers in. You look like the flying gun there, Ann.
Looks like horns.
Well, she's got horns.
Is that a redneck hat? It sure is.
Yep.
She got that at the county fair, didn't she?
Yep.
It's weird. Oh, fuck it.
Thank you for the pause up, Zeus.
Anywho, Phil, you know you could trim them way back, right?
I was told you trim them back to the almost the point where they look dead.
You'll trim them back like here. I'll show you. Let me put my cigarette in the ashtray. This will be pepper pruning 101.
So you're trimming them back. They're not going to. You're keeping them alive, but you're not trying to grow peppers.
All right. Can you see this very good? This single plant right here.
Yeah.
Okay. Then you see how it's got shoots down here.
Yep.
You cut it right there. All them shoots will branch back out.
Oh,
yeah.
You're gonna cut the whole top of that off.
Yeah.
Oh. Oh yeah.
And you'll have that much more new growth come out.
Yeah, because all these little, see them all shoots right here, where the old leaves fell off. Yeah. All those will become branches like these. Yeah. They'll all branch out.
Hmm. Crazy.
And it'll be more bushier.
Yeah. Bushy.
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 What?
Like, I don't know if you can see that. You see the trunk on that? See how fat that is? It's pretty big. It's every bit that big around on this one.
Wow.
Not that you can see it through the mess. But this will get all cut way back. Like all these long branches everywhere.
Yeah.
Get cut way back. And actually, we're going to make a bonsai out of that.
Mr. Miyagi.
Bianchi. But as soon as these are done making peppers, they'll all get cut way back. I've already got a handful of them in the basement already.
Really?
Yeah, I'll go down there and show you.
Yeah, part of me is, I don't know, I got to do, part of me is thinking about moving my grow light out in the basement, but then I can't, then I got, I won't be able to keep a warmer temperature. But again, I'm not trying to get them to grow there. I'm just trying to get them to stay alive.
Let's see. You've already grown them, Phil. You've already grown them. They don't need that temperature anymore.
No?
No. They just needs to be above freezing.
So I could put them in the basement. Do I need the grow light?
Oh, yeah. I'll show you.
Flip. As long as I get some light.
You see all my lights going? But this is no heater running. And
70.
Right.
It's 72 degrees in this
72.
Room.
Wow.
Well, see, my basement will probably be under 70.
Well, the rest of the basement is... Oh, let me flip this around so you can see me. The rest of the basement is probably 63 degrees. It's just the heat and the lights are keeping it warm in here.
Yeah. So I don't have another room other than the one I'm in right now in the basement without building another room.
I mean, and I'm only running. All these are all LEDs.
What's up, Lizelle? You know?
Yep.
And then I got just the fan blowing back and forth just to simulate some wind. Because these still have peppers on them and flowers everywhere. I mean, look at the size of that pepper.
Wow.
This whole plant's that big.
Yeah, and got peppers.
Yeah, I mean, here's a ghost pepper, I think.
So how did that blow peppers in the house? How did those grow peppers in the house? Did the fan blow hard enough so they pollinated?
Yeah.
Okay, because apparently my fan in here wasn't blowing. I didn't have an oscillating fan, and mine would make the leaves move a little, but nothing that I did would grow peppers in the house until I moved them outside.
Yeah. Well, mine really didn't either. I had a handful that did, but that's why remember I told you that you need the bugs and all that?
Yeah.
But my goal now is I don't care about the peppers producing, just keeping them alive, you know?
Right. That way when the time comes, you can have them start producing.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I just stick them outside and let them have at it. because a lot of them.
I want to try to keep my reapers going all winter long. It'd be nice to be able to, if I had to take the Q-tip and pollinate them that way, it'd be nice to have reapers growing all winter long.
Well, you better have one hell of a light source.
Oh, yeah?
Yep.
Because I think they need a lot of heat.
Well, they need the light. All the pepper plants need light, like real sunlight.
Right.
Like, I've got, like, it hurts my eyes to stand in this room because I got, you know, the reflective foil insulation. Right. But these plants don't see it as the same intensity as sunlight.
Huh.
Now, they'll grow like a raped ape, but they won't produce fruit, you know, for whatever reason. It's missing some kind of spectrum. I don't know what. All right, it's too hot in here for this fat guy. I'm getting out.
Everything okay?
Yeah, I think, the nightmare or something.
Oh, okay. Drew 92, what's up? You're on. What's happening, man? How you doing?
Hey, Adam. Where are you going?
Maybe I need to spend a few bucks in like a separate room. Off of this, I don't know. Crap.
Yeah, a lot of them plants on that trailer, Phil, are be a year old next month.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, mine I started in, mine didn't start till February.
I started all mine in end of October into November. You know, that's when I started everything. From seed. This is a lot of hard work. I don't want them to die.
Yeah, that's what we were just going over, Tim. Just getting them inside, keeping them warm, cutting them back. He just gave us a tutorial. You missed it.
Hold on. I want to tell Tim something I've been wanting to tell him for a long time. Let me go back, turn the lights back on, and go back in my pepper room. In the secret dungeon.
The torture chamber.
Yeah. All right. I've noticed Tim has those lights right there. These. I'm curious to how many he has. Because I think I've only ever seen one. And the reason being is they're only 45 watt, and unless you're going to put your plants 1 inch from them, they're not doing much good. You need a whole bunch of them. Or go to Home Depot. You turn the camera on. See this one right here? I can flip the different. I can make it all red, red and blue, all blue. You know, that's pretty bright. That's a lot brighter. But, you know, I've got one. You know, I got spotlights here, grow light, just a regular CFL. You know, more grow lights. You've got these long grow lights. CFL's running all daylight bulbs, this big LED shop light, another grow light. And I got more lights I could put in here. And it's still just barely enough to simulate sunlight. But your goal, Tim, is to not let them freeze. You know, keep them around, you know, average basement's around 60 degrees or so. You probably have a heated basement, so it'd probably be a little warmer in your basement. I know you had them in your kitchen when you started growing them, but your garage, I assume you park in and out of, so it'll get too cold in there unless you have it heated somehow. But they're already grown or whatever. You're not going to produce much for peppers during the winter, so your goal is to keep them from dying. from the cold. Any questions, get a hold of me.
What's up, Red Candles? Good to see you in here. Whole handful of peppers.
This is a pretty good size chocolate. Primos, too.
Mm-hmm.
It's a little pecker. Tim, you need to order two more off of Amazon.
I got like six small grow lights, and then I got four shop lights. But what I did is I went and got the grow lights. I think it was on Amazon.
Yeah. That's where all of them 1 foot square ones, LEDs, came from.
Yeah.
I was like, I don't know, what was it, like $40 on Amazon for the two pack?
Yeah.
So I have two packs of those. I mean, I could have a lot more. And they're supposed to cover 3 square feet each, as far as, you know, light projection. And, you know, I keep them probably a foot or so above the plants.
Which I also have those heating pads, you know, heating mats.
Well, you only need those for if you're germinating seeds.
Yep.
And you live where it's warm all the time, so you don't have to worry about none of that.
What you talking about? We fixed them be down to 48.
Oh, no.
That's cold.
That's not minus 20.
We don't get that cold.
Tim gets colder than that. But yeah. Yeah, no, as long as they don't freeze, they're fine, unless you're germinating seeds. Then you're going to want 80 degrees.
Yep.
Well, my greenhouse, but I know what he said.
The greenhouse last year, I kept it like 80 degrees the whole time in there.
Yeah.
Yeah, I kept mine between 75 and 80 in this bedroom last year. And there ain't no way I'm coming down here and doing my my thing down here in that kind of temperature.
You will be stripping.
I'll be down here in a tank top and a sun visor and making face down.
Yeah.
Yeah, you don't need to do all that, Phil. You just need to set them up on the ledge for the most part, you know?
Yeah.
How big's that ledge? I forget. Like a foot?
Maybe 10 inches. My saucers are bigger than that, so my saucers would hang over. But then they wouldn't get the good light from my grow light.
Yeah. Yeah, just, I don't know. I got mine all set on a timer, you know. Comes on at 7 o'clock in the morning, goes off at 11 o'clock at night.
Yeah, I've got a timer.
But you won't need, you just leave it your normal ambient house temperature, whatever it is down there. It's not going to obviously freeze.
And they'll live.
Oh, yeah. They'll live fine. Because all you're doing is overwintering them. You know, I've already sprayed this whole trailer and what's inside with neem oil already. I'll do it again before I fully take them inside.
Complicated love. How you doing?
Hey, hey, complicated love.
Yeah, I changed out the dirt, you know, and a lot of them. That way it's all got fresh dirt. Trim the root balls back. Just preparing them to go inside.
What's up, Michael?
What are you doing?
What else?
Y'all see? That's why. Mm-hmm. I wash dishes around the clock.
You don't wash them, you just put them in the dishwasher.
I still pre-wash them and stick them in the dishwasher.
Look.
Hey, Sherry. Sherry, there's a reason it's called a dishwasher.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. You don't have to wash them before you put them in there to wash them again.
I pre-wash mine.
So do I.
Well, you realize your dishwasher has a disposal built into it, right?
I know that, but still. I like my stuff clean. I just don't like being someone putting a dirty plate in the dishwasher. I know it's going to be washed, but just seeing the food on there.
Let the dog lick it off first.
Jerry Berry, that's her son.
Do what, Brad?
Let the dog lick it off first.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Then I'll be bleaching or throwing it that plate away.
But he just ate a turd. That was it.
Oh.
Jim Bob's loving. Oh, we lost Jeremy. Luca Fitness, how you doing?
Come back, Pepper.
Open Cameron's turn for the laptop. Hot sauce junkie, Tim. We'll get paper plates. We go through a lot of paper plates in this house.
That don't work around here. My husband won't use them.
No?
No.
Because a lot of stuff that we do, you know, the kids get pizza, paper plates. You know, I make a sandwich, paper plate.
Well, that's different. Try to eat a steak on a paper plate.
We can't eat a steak on a paper plate. We're not eating a lot of steak around here. If you're eating a lot of steak over there, I don't know. But
well, come on, Laura. You wouldn't be having panel withdrawals.
Come on, girl.
She booked it up there.
She said she ain't got no Wi-Fi, she said.
I see you.
You guys like, we like hot sauce too, Michael.
Oh, where's Pepper?
I don't know. He popped off all of a sudden.
Oh.
Pepper's come back.
Michael.
It's not his turn to use the laptop anymore.
I tried that, Tim. It don't work.
I think Cameron told him, he said, Dad, it's my turn.
It's my turn. I need
Cameron on the laptop.
But she just couldn't help herself. It's been an hour since she was in here the first time. She couldn't help herself. There she is.
Happy now we are happy. Hey, R5.
It could be so right, Jerry.
I'm doing this to make you happy, Crazy Ad. To make you happy.
Who in heck is that?
Oh my gosh, it's J Dub. What's up, J Dub? J-Dub Vlogs, yeah.
Thanks, Spicy. Hey, Crazy Ann. Hey, Farfax.
Oh. Look at all that background noise.
What?
Not me.
Sorry, I was opening my crush grate. I had to set the phone on the grill.
Okay, Radar.
Putt-putt, I was not planning on coming on tonight. I was planning on getting other things done, and I should have just not come to the stream at all with that intention.
What are you doing, woman?
It's complicated love. I can see that.
That's a complicated hairstyle.
Yeah. That is J Dub.
I think it's the first time we've been on a panel together there, J Dubs. I'm never sure of it.
All right, I'm going to let Peppers come up. I just wanted to come up and speak to everybody. He's done. Yeah.
He ain't in the room, waiting room if you want to hang around. Hang on.
Peppers had to give his son the laptop.
I told you he did. I told you he did.
Yeah.
It's his son's turn. Dad, your 2 hours are up.
My kids are sleeping.
I hope mine are sleeping. He should be. He's got school in the morning.
All right, I thought my daughter the one night.
I'm gonna drop down, Spicy.
Okay.
Thank you.
See you, J-Dub.
Bye, y'all. Sweet dreams.
Good night. I caught my daughter the one night after I told her to go to bed. She popped into Premier Hellstream, said, "Hey, kitty cat, I'm in here hanging out." I was in there, and I'm like, "Oh, kid, you better get your butt to bed." You ain't in here hanging out. You're going to bed.
You're going to bed. I'm taking that phone if I have to.
Well, I told her, I'm like, "I'm on my way up to grab your phone." She's like, "Oh, no, I need my alarm." I'm like, "You need to get your butt to bed."
Did you get any on you there, Brad?
What? I'm picking peppers.
That's what it sounded like.
So, is chips officially done, Sherry?
Huh?
Those chips officially done?
Yes.
I came in as you were talking about the chips, but I didn't really hear what you were saying.
Did you order some R5?
Right now, I got to get through some financial stuff.
Well, they're already gone then. She's already sold them all. Yeah. So.
I sold 100 bags.
Yeah, considering the car I got and I'm having to go right back to the shop and it's at the shop right now, I'm kind of
Gotcha.
It's been Brad's a fun running.
Run. He's running. He's running.
Have a good night, Brad.
What are you doing, Brad? What is that?
Who do you think they are?
Are they peppers?
Dried peppers?
Sherry, tell them what they are.
Cookies?
He made some chips, guys, with my homemade recipe.
Ah, okay.
But he used a cookie cutter on his. And I think he made his a little bit thicker.
Ah.
They look like flour cookies.
I'll leave that joke alone. I'd bite my tongue on that. I didn't have the patience of Sherry to roll that sticky goo out that thin. It was bad enough I used one cup of flour and I had 45 other cups of flour on everything else.
He told me to cook it for him.
Yeah, I'll doctor it up. You cook it.
So he made those chips and said, "I'll never do this again."
Well, I might try it again, but I'm trying to do it on the stovetop. I might use the kitchen table where I got room.
It's usually a good idea when you're doing stuff like that.
Well, I was trying to keep the mess as small as possible.
How'd that work for you?
Not very. Like, I put wax, I was obviously flour residue on the glass top stove. And I put wax paper on top of it, thinking, I'll roll it on that. I chased wax paper and dough around the stove forever. You know how hard it is to use a rolling pin one-handed and hold the wax paper?
Nope.
I was a hot mess.
What about parchment paper? Wouldn't a parchment paper have been better?
It was the same thing.
No, yeah, that's the same thing there.
Parchment paper and wax paper ain't the same thing.
It's still going to get slippery and run around in a stupid stove. I know they're different.
How you doing, Ann?
She's rubbing her everything okay. Spicy.
Yeah. You got it, brother.
Brad.
What?
Go to Walmart. Get you a fondant roller, okay? It's not a wood, okay?
Jerry, put your toys away.
Roll out your chill dough.
Oh, hey, I
man.
I'm a glutton for punishment.
Hey, my sexy dumpling.
A sexy dumpling?
Sherry, you're going to laugh at this. What's wrong with... Wrong person. Philip. What's wrong with my $2 wooden one with the bent handle? And it's broke.
Because...
It rolls.
The dough will stick to it.
You think?
That, because you're making chips, okay?
Tim got us on that one.
But this works better.
How much is that?
The you're only paying $3 for it. Not a way, you know, you're not pushing all the flour off of your parchment paper.
Yeah, but Brad's got cheap wood.
And don't push it hard enough, Brad.
I got that too, but I don't use that.
I like to put my wood roller on my shoulder. No, I obviously don't do a lot of dough rolling, Sherry. That might have been the first time ever.
No, that's your wife does a lot of dough rolling.
Hey, Eve.
What's up, Eve Bubbles?
Eve. You're lurking.
I know Jerry's trying so hard to be serious and everyone's just laughing.
Exactly right.
She's like, I give up with you guys, man.
It was like earlier when Faith said she burnt her tongue on her taco. It was like we all just busted up laughing. It was like, okay.
Oh man, Sherry got a big one.
She's got a bigger wood than you.
She's just got some quality wood.
Hers isn't cracked or anything. It's not like malformed.
Well, that rolling pin was a nice rolling pin until I used it to crush a big chunk of chocolate with it once and as a hammer. It didn't work out very good.
Yeah, show me that red one that you have again there, Ann.
Look at Crazy Ann.
It's nice. It's very nice, Tina. Yeah.
Put your meat away. PG.
Look at my.
Leave it. This kid get his meat out. Come on.
The handle is so nice, and yeah.
And then Crazy Ann stroking her object.
You got to stroke it there, Crazy Ann. We don't need to see where you're practicing. Just in private, please.
Bad Ann, bad, bad, bad Ann, bad.
What's up with him?
Sherry's gonna pee.
Tim for sure did not work.
I don't think that's where the work is supposed to happen. I think it's in the middle or the work.
Oh. I didn't know. But it's so good. Look at it. It's so good.
Oh, it's awfully shiny.
Oh, wow. <well. laughs>
They went there. Did you?
Are you all right? Are you blushing? I feel it's blushing.
Phil, I've never seen you turn red.
He's having hot flashes over there.
Oh my god, this is why I ended up joining panel after I said I was not joining panel, because it turns into this.
Well, look at the company you're in.
Yeah.
Are you okay? You're all a little not right in the head, right?
You know, I wish I could give Sherry a spanking with my special for putting me in the basement on her on the last stream that I was on of her.
Dude, only one person can spank me and you ain't him.
Yeah. Oh, is that stream? Like, yeah. This is getting a little creepy.
Speaking of, here's Longwood. I mean, Pedro Longwood.
Yeah,
apparently we're on a Spice Channel now.
It's USA up all night.
I love you, Sherry. You know that.
I love you too.
Tread lightly on words you choose to use right now, Sherry. Yeah, I think your shirt was out used on the wrong stream today for a representation.
Pedro.
Hey, Pay.
I feel.
And
Jerry said, "I'm out."
She's like, "This is getting out of hand. I'm going."
She's going to the garage.
Oh. Oh.
You moved me away from my hand. What the heck?
Hi there. So I can handle stuff like, yeah.
Easy now. Okay. Now I got a fever again.
Well, you know, I have a new three-word name for you, Anne. What? Country crazy Anne. I love you, country crazy Anne.
I love you too, Angel.
Well, the reason why I call you Country Crazy Ann is because of that red cap that you have that reminds me of the country states.
How's that pepper you just ate, Chileno? What pepper did you eat? Do you know what you ate? What's up, back to fishing, Greg?
There, I feel left out with all the hands on the screen.
Yeah, you do.
Country states. Yeah, no pepper. That's the thing. Country states.
I didn't know we were switching to all cowboy hats.
Man,
I was feeling a bit left out, and my Wonder Woman hat ain't out here, so.
Wonder Woman hat.
You want
Wonder Woman wears an outfit.
I got a Wonder Woman baseball cap, and I got my cowboy hat. I'm going for the outfit. My punishment said next to the computer since Crazy Hamstring, I think it was. Oh, God. You've already beat the wood enough, okay, Crazy Ed? Let it get its color back.
Yeah, put your red rocket away.
This stream is demonetized.
What? This is our cooking channel.
Is it?
They started it. Hot sauce, tincture, and rolling pin.
They started it. Sherry on the bread. Yeah.
Sherry was having a cooking channel too till she starts spanking her chicken.
Yeah. Yeah, I did, but fucking. Hi, honey. Hi.
Shane, you're gonna sit in the shadows and watch, right?
Sherry, are you in my garage?
I'm in mine.
Looks like you're in mine.
She's like, no, I'm in mine. Anywhere.
Where is Sherry? I don't see her.
So you guys don't use the garage to cars, but peppers. Okay.
Yeah. Cars can stay outside. Peppers are more important.
Yeah.
I don't use my garage for cars either because my garage is filled with ATVs and a boat and all that stuff. There's no room in my garage anymore. It's fun trying to get from one end to the other. You pretty much between a million things.
Phil, I have an idea. No, take me off it.
He forgot his idea. He's on spotlight.
No. Not. Your pole barn. Move your tractor and your lawnmower into the normal garage. It's already full of stuff. And make a grow house in there.
Yeah, but I think it'd be too hard to keep it because the walls in there aren't insulated at all. I think it'd be too hard, too expensive to keep a room heated in there.
Well, that's what I was going to say. A pole barn typically isn't insulated at all, so the draft is going to go right through there.
Yeah.
I know, but his barn is built like a house.
I just got wooden metal walls. I don't have any insulation. I mean, if I did it in there, I'd have to insulate that. I mean, I guess I could do that, but I'd have to, like, build a – you know the problem with my pole – you know what the problem with my pole barn is right now? I got two of my kids' junk. Yeah, my daughter moved back from New York. I got half of her crap from her house in there because she's living in a trailer now. My son and his fiance are living with my mother-in-law right now where they're trying to find a place. I got 90% of their crap in my pole barn. The pole barn will be for my crap because I can't fit any more of my crap in the garage. So my crap goes out to the pole barn, not everybody else's crap.
Crazy.
Well,
everyone else's crap's going in there.
That's right.
Supposed to
be just crap.
See, I
mean, have a threaten a bonfire, they'll get it out.
Tomatoes.
You gonna eat that?
No, I want to show you this almost perfect symmetrical pepper. Look at this.
Wow.
Looks like a little pumpkin.
Cute one.
It does. Just the tip is green.
Just the tip.
Oh, the tip.
Sherry's walking laps around her peppers.
She's doing the Christmas dance. Oh, shake it, baby. Yeah, move that booty. Come on.
What's up, G Kicks? How you doing, man?
How are you doing? Yeah.
How are you doing?
Eat it, Brad.
I'm picking peppers up.
Go ahead. Hey, if you want to, G Kicks, go ahead and post it in the chat, dude. I don't care.
You don't care.
Huh?
You don't care.
I no, you know what? I allow people to do stuff. I don't want them just to do it on their own. You say you got a new video, I tell them to put it in my chat.
Man, Laura, that's insane.
Not too much then.
That's right. Only the rain put on it. That looked like she copied and pasted that from like 2 weeks ago when she was having the same problem. Water's going underneath the cooker.
Yeah, Laura, you can do that.
Yes, you can.
Do what?
Her GoFundMe thing for her son.
Yeah.
It would have been better when we had, you know, 30 plus people in here. Barefoot Adventures is here. What's up, Barefoot Adventures? I'm going to act really dumb right now because it's not coming to me, but it doesn't come to me most of the time. What the hell is your first name?
It's not coming to me either.
I don't know.
And I've heard it a time or two, and for some reason it never comes to me whenever I see him. It's Yeehaw. Yeehaw is your first name?
Fred.
That's when you said the reverse cowgirl or something.
I'm sorry, God. The
reverse cowgirl? Is that what you're talking about?
Yeah, what's this one?
Hello.
So there's Laura's GoFundMe page for her son, for memorial for her son.
You should type some.
Nick's latest video.
Laura, you should.
Sneakers.
Yeah, Laura should pick that, right?
Fashion and sneakers.
Yeah.
You may be Fred, Mr. Yeehaw, Mr. Yaw.
What?
Mr. Haw.
I uploaded a very important video. Can I post the link? I'm barefoot. You should put something else in the link, Laura. Not just put out the link, but type something with it.
Yeah.
I swear to God, the more
Laura, you should never feel rude about doing anything. Just ask, and it's cool.
Stye!
Stye North is in the house. What's up, Stye North?
Stye North! Thank
you! You know, Crazy Ann, the more I hang around with you, the more I want to pack up your sexy head and sexy looks of you and just keep it for myself as a precious package of mine. That-
I didn't mean that.
Be careful, Ann. Your head's
you
off.
Thank you, Phil.
Your head's off. Like the be careful.
I saw Phil.
There was a movie about that, wasn't there?
A movie.
Like someone carrying around someone's head.
Yeah, Phil's got my back, so yeah.
At least this time, I didn't get called a Barney.
Angel, I haven't put you up yet. Are you done being creepy?
I'm actually he's a creepy.
I ain't having any creepy people on my panel.
Keep them in the basement.
Yeah, I know we love Speed Laura. I know.
It's just out of respect there, Ann. Oh, man. You're just a fun person, Ann, I swear.
I know. I love you. I love you, Ann. You have to behave. Phil put in the basement, you know.
Phil's like, nope. You're the one time I had someone on panel and they started going on and on about something I did not want on my panel.
I think you can handle the lutefisk, Tim.
Do you think you can find lutefisk?
Lutefisk?
Yeah.
Yeah? Do you want to try that?
Sure. You can't find it around here. It'd be like just like the sastrami trying to find it.
G-Kick,
yeah. What's up? Jeremy's
like, find the single
woman,
please.
How can I do that? Angel, you need to hit on single woman, dude. Pepper says that.
That laugh, dude.
I know, right?
We love you, Angel.
I love all you guys as well.
Okay, I feel slow asking this, but Krayson is not single? No.
Nope. Nah. I know that answer.
No. Nope. I'm not. I have a lot of men. All right.
He's got gunner, and he's got guns.
Yeah, and a woman and men. Yeah, it's all the same. Bring it on.
You're a junkie RO. What's up, man? How you doing?
I have guns. Ha. Huh.
You didn't realize that putt-putt.
I think we all do.
Everybody, yeah, the closest friend knew that, but yeah, it's not all that know that.
Laura says, she's mine.
Yeah, I know you want me between your legs, Laura. Or was it opposite?
Something not quite as hot.
What?
Well, Brad's got eaten now.
Not a banana. Oh. Looks like a banana. You love it between my legs. Yeah. I wish I would be up. Yeah. I'm stopped there. Yep.
Crystal, if you ever know Laura, Laura's always streaming from her cell phone. So in order to have her cell phone far enough away, she's usually got her cell phone between her knees. So it's kind of the ongoing joke that, you know, we're all between Laura's legs when she's streaming. So.
I know she streams off her cell phone. Didn't know that's how she held it.
That's awesome.
It like a corn cob. He's not eating the seed.
But too many seeds. You sell them?
That's a lot of damn seeds. But that can't be a hot pepper.
It's a hot wax.
Okay. Hungarian.
Oh. A guy at work gave me a whole bunch of jalapenos and wax peppers or something.
Something.
It's free. It's for me.
There you go.
No.
Peppers are good.
Doing well now. If Brad's working on turning this into a little bit of ASMR as he eats the pepper with all that crunching.
Right?
Now for my final trick, a Kool-Aid jammer.
I swear to God. Oh, you want
to see that one, Phil? Yeah, I know. Oh, God.
He's like, nope, switch it off now.
Hi, honey. You blush again? Yeah, you did.
Are you in bed?
No. No, I'm not going to bed, Sherry, but I might bring you into bed with me since you kicked me off of your...
Phil, you'd learn your lesson by now, haven't you? Keep him off.
I don't always have this positioned right to it. He, you know, he's the last person, so I had to scroll the screen down before I could punch on him. are you done being creepy, Angel? She's a married woman.
Who is?
Sherry. Sherry's like, I am. Actually, all the women on the panel are married, okay?
No, I'm not married.
She's free. He was extra touching himself for that one.
Hey, Jojo.
Don't make me Randy.
Jojo in the house.
Jojo.
Jojo, what's up, brother?
Hi, Jojo.
I thought Jojo was lost. Hey, Jojo.
Come up, brother.
Angel out. There you go. There's the link for you. Are you done, creepy boy?
I'm just trying to have fun with you, Sherry, especially the night of the stream when you like put me in your basement. When I was just laughing my butt off that everyone wanted. And if my laugh scares you, then I guess I need to creep you out this Halloween.
Pepper want to come up if Dodger don't.
There's like a big purple dinosaur he'd abused.
Purple? Sometimes purple?
Well, she was referred to as Barney before, so.
Mip, 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 mip. Mip, mip. Oh, yeah. Right there. Ooh.
Peppers.
Peppers. Laugh. Let's live. Let's live, Laura. Live.
It's a typo.
Yeah, I know.
Typo.
No.
Oh, goodness.
Come on up, Dojo.
How are you doing, Phil? You want me to put it? He's gone. Who is putting up now? Pepper? Dojo? Oh. You hide now.
He's leaving the stream. This isn't a safe spot.
Hey, Pilo.
This isn't a safe spot, okay?
Phil, you got anybody in the basement?
No. We're looking for a replacement for Angel.
Now we accept the application. It's a short one.
No, I was talking about for me.
What's that?
I was talking about
right there,
for me.
Brad.
Hey, Peter. Right there.
Why, are you taking a break for a second?
Well, I gotta pee.
Well, we don't want to see you pee.
Crazy Ann does.
What?
What?
What now? I was typing what?
I guess I'm gonna need to take a shit on the poop deck then with you there is.
The kid can't keep his mouth shut.
Oh, okay. Lord.
Oh, boy.
Dojo is coming up. He don't feel so well.
Peppers, join us.
Peppers, please.
Fill the panel up.
Come on, Peppers.
See, the funny part is this is still entertaining. This is still entertaining to me because I can still see Angel down here.
I know.
You guys can't all see him, but I can see him. Hey, Angel, how you doing, buddy?
He's got a bad tummy.
I'm just trying to have a great time with all you guys and girls.
We're having
a good time. I'm just going to show you how what a mama does to somebody that does something like that.
She gonna whoop you, boy.
With that roller pin thing. Check your behind back behind the shed and wear that little butt out. You respect people.
Good night, Tim.
Don't talk like that.
Sherry. Sherry.
Yeah.
That's kind of hot.
Oh, man.
See you later, Tim.
Good night, Tim.
Good night, Tim. Good night, John Boy.
I don't know who said he lit him.
Brad's like, can I take his position, please?
Cappers.
Where's that coming from?
Pepper.
Hold on, I'm Pepper. Trying to echo.
I think you're echoing Peppers.
He said, hold on a minute, it's Peppers.
He said, hold on a minute, it's Peppers.
Come back.
Please come back,
Phil. Get up here.
Good night, Tim.
Good night, Tim.
Good night, Tim.
Good night, Tim.
Good night,
Tim.
Good night,
Tim. Good night, John. We're going to repeat back.
What are you doing, Pepper? Poppers.
He's on his cell phone. What are you doing, Pepper?
He muted.
He's like, I'll sit here muted just to fill the spot, okay?
We don't hear you, Peppers.
It's because he's muted because he was echoing.
He muted himself. He's playing all our stuff right back at us.
It's because he's muted because he was echoing. See? For some reason, it's on a delay.
He's playing all our stuff right back at us. Back in, maybe it'll work.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, still echoing.
See?
All right, guys.
Punishment, aren't
my
you?
My phone's about on 30%, and it's 12:30.
Oh, I'm sleepy.
Good night, Brad.
Night, Brad.
And
good night, Brad.
And I keep getting more perverse, so I better go.
Bye, Brad.
Bye.
Bye, Brad. So are we that throw me off every time you do that.
We just lost Peppers. Maybe he comes in again and won't be delayed.
Maybe.
Are you comfortable there, Angel?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And reach over there and smack him.
I'm comfortable with your fur R5.
Fuck it.
My what?
He's gone.
He's gone. Oh, pocket that.
He said something about your fur.
Oh.
Not that you've got any fur R5 or crystal, but
I'm fluffy, I guess. Okay. Last I checked, I wasn't a dog or a cat or anything, but
look, Phil. Look.
Oh, God.
Mm-hmm. Hi.
I'm shuffling everybody. I'm getting good at this shuffling thing tonight.
Yeah, you are.
I'm trying to create some humor with you guys in some form of strange way. Yes, it may be a bit odd, but that's just how I roll.
You like it hot.
I know I'm going to find the love of my life someday, and I know all you girls are married women, but the thing is, we all have to have fun in our life. My kind of fun is strange.
I'm not married, Angel.
Then maybe I should take a rope and bring you with me.
Yeah, maybe.
Angel, you're too much,
dude. I'm sending out the SOS now.
I shouldn't told him that but the thing.
It puts the lotion on the skin or else it gets the hose again.
Oh, man.
There's no telling how many women Angel's got tied up in his basement of his house right now.
Yeah, never know. Never know. Dojo, oh my god.
Oh, I'm sure we can find out, but I don't want to find out, so we're good.
Are you sure?
Oh, I'm sure. I'm positive.
Angel would be a nice man to you, R5. Crystal.
I'm good where I'm at. One man's enough for me, and I'm good where I'm at.
I can't say what I want to say. What's that?
No, you can pretty much say anything there, Peppers.
I was told you can't say something nice, don't say nothing at all, so I'm trying to be nice here, but it's really getting hard.
Is it getting hard?
What?
I don't know.
Is it? Tell me, is it?
Right. Yeah, it was. Oh, Phil.
Phil.
You can't leave us with this. You can't leave us with this.
No, you can't.
Come back.
Come back.
Come back up, Phil. Come back up, Phil.
But Maddie, yeah, you're kind of honest there.
I don't want to show.
Hey, Roger.
Roger, you want to join?
Come join us, please.
Oh, man.
Phil, get your butt back up here.
Hey, easy, Bill.
Oh, God.
Don't worry. Hi. Like
hi.
Well, good night.
Hi.
She's just trying to answer a question, okay?
What?
Good night. Good night.
I just want to feel.
A little bit of a play on words there, Ed.
Yeah. Words, right?
Good night, Shane.
I just want to feel. Feel. Howdy.
All right, it's good.
That was better.
Die.
Die.
We're safe. Die, my
man. Hi, Sherry. Hi, Ann. Oh, hi. Angel. Ain is in the house. Hi, Crystal. Oh, hi, Phil, the host.
Okay. I think I kind of did the same thing when I came in today. I said, I'm like, yeah, I'm not coming up on panel. And then all of a sudden it's, hi, Sherry. Hi, Crazy Ann. Hi, Brad. Oh, yeah. Hi, Phil.
Oh, by the way, Phil.
And then I ended up on panel anyway.
Yeah. These good girls are so great that they think I'm attacking.
I really like that, Phil, that option.
It works real well. Thank you.
Ooh, hide down
shadow. Oh, there he is.
The dark cramping.
That was an accidental butt. Oops. Didn't know that was the butt. Oops.
I'm in the dark cramping.
What did you eat?
This time, hot damn.
Good to see you again, Yorin. Hey, did you catch my comment? I said I've got a basement we can put Angel in. It's out in my outhouse.
Yeah. That's all right.
He can make himself right at home out there.
Is that where you
and
been
I'll
keeping
stop
Andy?
In once a day to check on
maybe you can put me in my underwear in your basement.
If you were in my basement, I'd never look down there.
He's got his underwear on top of his head.
They're clean.
Yep. Yeah. Sherry's like, that's just, yeah. Don't regurgitate anything you've ate today, Sherry.
I'm very close.
Yeah, yeah, isn't that just appetizing? Like that one stream when he was showing off his dirty socks. Like, oh, I wanted to crawl right through the internet, shove them socks down his throat.
I want to crawl out of the internet and evade at all costs because just the thought of touching those dirty socks would make me sick.
Oh, I was willing to wash my hands in some acid after the fact just to shove them socks down his throat.
Oh my god.
So you've been keeping Andy in that same dungeon because I haven't seen that man anywhere lately.
I wanted to shove him up his rear end, but then I didn't want to get his rear end dirty. That's how bad them socks were. I mean, I'd never seen nothing like that. I thought they were going to get up and run out of the room.
They're working on disintegrating.
Trust me, Sty isn't looking for Andy anywhere. Whenever Andy's not on one of Sty's streams, he stays monetized.
Hey, I think YouTube gave up. I had 7 limited monetizations, and they were all when I had Andy through the whole stream for hours. Every one of them. They monetized them all. I couldn't believe it. I go, I think they gave up on him. That's a new standard. That's an Andy streams. Go ahead and monetize it. Advertisers must be saying, yeah, everybody wants to watch him.
But you know, I wouldn't mind having the Sty standard.
Thank you.
Sty's like, you know, they said Andy's a lost hope. That's just Andy's Andy.
Yep. Yeah, I was starting to call my streams the Sty and Andy show.
I ate too many super hot peppers and my spaghetti, a little too much. Well, a lot. Wow.
Oh.
How many peppers was a little too much?
Yeah, how many peppers was a little too much, Roger? Did you have like a 20 Reaper spaghetti?
That's what I was wondering too, is yeah.
That's what Bill was trying to get his wife to
Trying to cheer me up, huh?
Yeah, Evie's one of our blind YouTubers.
Yeah.
Hey, she's over at my channel. She's a devoted listener. It's my voice she loves. It's handsome. I had someone ask me on a stream tonight I was on. I was on a panel, and they asked me, they said, Why do you do what you do? And I said, because I'm so damn handsome. I said, I got to show myself off to the world. Why else do you think I got a YouTube channel?
Andy is a good guy.
I'm sorry, he's gone.
Oh, God.
Don't put me in the basement with Angel. Don't do it.
You guys are a great couple of people.
That's elder abuse.
That's elder abuse.
Scare the hell out of me.
Oh, no, help. That's worse than the chocolate that never
Angel, all alone, and the lights were off.
All I could hear was a stupid giggling.
Yeah, you hear that in a dark, pitch black room? Oh, my God. I'd be digging a tunnel out of there.
I'd shit myself. There's no way. There's no way.
Yeah. Wouldn't bother Angel with his dirty socks.
That sounds too much like a clown, that laugh. I just couldn't do it. I'm out.
I actually, one night after being on a stream with Angel and that crazy laugh of his, I actually went and I pulled up a documentary on lions and hyenas, and them hyenas were chattering. He was in there. He was in that pack. I heard him. Sounds just like a hyena. Listen to him. I can hear that low.
he's trying not to let it out.
Only about 7 reapers and some yellow mustard pods. Only 7 reapers.
Yeah, I've been in here for only 7. Yeah. Oh yeah. What the heck? What the heck? Yeah, let's just throw 7 reapers in something Italian. I mean, God Almighty. I mean,
I think what I'm going to do with the last peppers I have, I'm going to freeze them up and try to use them in like chili or something.
I don't think I'd be able to handle any one of the peppers that you guys tried over the last 6 months or so, because I don't know when you started this whole spicy thing, even though your channel is everything spicy. But I know not that long ago, R5, you tried your first ever pepper, and you didn't succeed all that well. And with these kind of peppers, nah-uh. I don't think I'll handle it, not even just the teeniest pinch.
We're going to come down in that basement, hold your ass down, and shove your mouth full of them.
Hey, Roger. Hey,
Roger. I'm just getting my stuff here ready, so bear with me.
Hope you feel better.
Oh, I'm cramping up and done. It could come and go.
Oh, it's Phil that's missing. I'm going... Everybody's here.
Because the host can remove themselves and make room for another panelist while still being the host of the stream.
Sure can.
That's better.
Looking pretty good.
Thanks.
I don't think I've ever seen you cramping up over there, Roger.
Okay, Google, turn on that damn stove.
Sure, turning on 3 outlets.
All right.
Sorry, it looks like the desk overhead light isn't available.
Okay, that's enough.
Okay, that's fine.
With Google.
Yeah, so what's up, everyone?
I thought he was talking to Angel for a minute there. Okay, that's enough.
Got a little Angel and the Devil in my shoulder.
No more from you.
Hey, Siri.
Oh, you got him from Brad?
Yeah. It's a lot bigger than I thought it would be.
He made his bigger. Right. He used a cookie cutter.
Oh, he used a cookie cutter? Yeah. He
didn't thin him out as much as he should have.
No.
This is disgusting already.
I'm just going to open it. I'm not sure I'm going to eat them yet because I'm still cramping.
Even, like, thank you.
Take a whoop at it.
Now, I don't know what this
is. Well, I was going to he uses the same as yours. Oh, that's what uses the same as you got, right?
Oh, okay.
I mean, I actually smells pretty good, though.
Yeah, you said you weren't
going to
have one.
I got to do it.
He's like, I'm already prepped, but I'll put another one.
And you know you can't eat just one.
You see how to coat it?
Did he overcook them?
I thought flaky, just like a packing. It does smell really good. I mean, it's like night and day.
He got the recipe from me.
Oh, okay.
I'm not going to have one.
But see, he made his with, I think, yellow corn.
He overcooked it.
He did?
He burned it. But I do like burnt toast and burnt bacon. So it is pretty good, though.
Yeah, I told him. I says, you kind of look like you overcooked them. He said he has turned out kind of like a cracker. I'm like, what'd you do? Put too much flour?
Well, it sounds like he didn't roll them out enough.
No, because he said it was really sticky.
He was also using a wood rolling pin.
Yeah.
There's a lot of issues there.
Yep.
I'm thinking.
He's thinking.
Now just wait till you get mine.
Yeah.
It's on his way.
That I wouldn't want to
but, do. I have to say, it tasted a whole lot better. It does. Like, it does have some heat to it. I'm trying to figure out how many packy chip equal to one of that chip.
Notice he's saying how many packy chips, meaning there's multiple packy chips.
I think it's probably one. a little bit more than more than one packy chip.
I cut the dough into strips and then I cut them into triangles.
It's definitely something I would snack on.
I'm coming out.
I'm waiting for you to say, you said I can't do two. Let's see about that.
That jalapeno ranch sounds pretty good. I can see snacking on that. I don't know about snacking on these ones.
They're a little warm.
What's that?
I like a little warm. I just don't like.
But they're not as hot as the Reaper ones. The Reaper ones are the ones that's really hot.
See, I got to try something that's got Reaper in it, I think. But I did eat the Reaper in those noodles, and that was okay. It was the straight Reaper, just no way. It just didn't work. That straight Reaper did not work out.
No.
Yeah, you did a good job on the noodles, Crystal. You did a really good job on those.
Dude, the noodles, it was okay. I could handle it. It was hotter, but I could handle it.
Yeah. Yeah, when you did the... just the raw pepper, boy, you were struggling with that, boy.
I think my problem is the raw pepper. I just don't like, I think it's the taste of a raw pepper with nothing else to it. It gets me.
Uh-huh.
Because it's mind over matter for me. And once I start thinking something's disgusting, it's over.
Yeah, it is.
Kind of where I was with that Reaper. I was starting to think, oh, this isn't good. And then it was over.
Yeah.
Well, I finally sit down. And I videoed. I hadn't put the video up yet. I ate 12 of my chips.
12 of them?
I was literally crying. Oh. I had tears rolling.
And how many did you have for the challenge?
12.
And you didn't record it?
Yeah. I just got to edit and post it.
Oh, okay. I would say if you didn't record it, it didn't happen.
I recorded it.
Like my girl.
But it was rough. I'm going to warn you. And you will have stomach cramps afterwards.
So how many orders do you have in so far? How many orders you had so far?
100 of my reapers are gone.
How many?
100.
Ordered? Wow.
I was up till 4:30 a.m. finishing off those orders. I sent off most of them this morning. I got some more I got to send off in the morning.
I'm proud of you. That's good. That's awesome.
But, I mean, I ain't making anything. I'm just doing, you know, letting people pay the shipping. You know, I just want to see, kind of give everybody a challenge maybe they want to try.
Gotcha. Okay. Nice.
But now I'm going to be having some candy.
So you're giving me 100 of them, right? Can I eat them all?
You want 100?
That's what I asked when she said she sold 100. I was thinking, what, did Roger order 90 or something?
I said, no.
I didn't order anything yet. So
we got something taken care of, though, Roger. I told everybody, you made my design.
Yeah, I'll help out what I can. Yeah. I wish I could spend more time on that. Yeah, well, I got a phone call from Brian from Repeat who wanted me to redesign, what's the name? Crazy Cumberland. And he's working on a next Astral of Evil 2.0. So he wants all the design to be consistent throughout. So I got to design that for him.
Cool.
Yeah, I never had Crazy Cumberland one. The one had bacon infused.
Yeah, I've been wanting it, but it's sold out.
Every time I go, it's sold out.
It's limited edition for what I've heard. So, pretty cool.
R5, wake up.
I'm awake.
Oh, okay.
I'm looking at my phone. I had a message come through, so I was trying to see what was up.
Now I got a portable studio. Yeah.
The reason I'm not in my office is because I'm redoing my office.
Going to have something like this? Or pretty tough in the background?
It's going to be really nice when I get through.
Uh-huh. That's cool.
Did you move everything out of your office?
Yeah, it's down my hallway.
Oh, wow. Wow.
And in my living room.
Oh, no.
Had to kind of get everything where it'll look right.
Yeah. And you were painting the whole office, right?
Yes.
Yeah. That's going to be neat, though. I can't wait till it's done.
And plus trying to hide something behind that big sheet. It was hard.
Well,
I can't do that in the room, so I'm going to go.
I was late.
Cholino.
Hey, Cholino.
You know, it's late there. Steve, believe getting up for the morning.
Hey, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's in that time where I think I'm going to dip out because I'm getting tired.
Good night, R5.
I was technically tired when I got on the panel. I wasn't planning on doing a panel because I had a couple things to do, and I'm like, I'm going to bed early tonight. You see how well that worked out.
Well, that's great, Crystal. You're making room for Angel.
Hey. Oh, yeah, make me feel guilty.
Yeah, look at what you're going to do to us, Crystal. Yeah, I was going to bed early tonight, too. That, yeah, really working out well.
Yeah, see, it didn't work out well for me either. Good night, Sherry. Phil.
Good night.
Bye. Night.
Good night. Love you. Yeah. Bye-bye.
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 So it must taste good.
I'll be back.
I'm good. I just wanted him to bring me back on so I can say goodnight to everyone as well, because I'm gonna be starting my full official position at my volunteer job tomorrow. Last week was just a orientation, but tomorrow I'll finally be able to do some physical work finally. And I appreciate each and every one of you. And just so we're on the same page, girls, did I do anything or did I harm you in any way? Or was it all for last to you, girls? Because you girls know me, don't you?
Yeah, I know you.
We know you.
Yeah, well, I know you from 3 miles away.
And you girls didn't seem any form of offended or anything. But we all love each other and we just have fun with one another, right?
Yeah, we do.
Yeah, we'd have a blast beating the tar out of you.
Stein, what am I going to do with you, my the Duck Dynasty redneck?
I don't have no redneck.
Good night!
Thank you, Bill.
Yeah, he took himself out. I didn't do that. He took himself out.
Oh, did he?
Yeah.
I thought you did it. I was going to say, boy, you're really building you're just building the friendships tonight. Just,
I tell you.
You're a good man, boy. I tell you.
Roger just left.
Roger just hopped.
Froze on you. I had to make coffee. Because guess what? I had to make some more chips.
Tonight? You already made them all.
I did, but I got to make some of the jalapeno ranch chips.
Ah.
I can do those in the house, thank God.
So the other ones you said you make outside, you actually make them in the garage?
Well, I took them out on the main patio. What I did is I cooked the actual chips in the oven. But what I did is while they're still hot, I put the spices on them. Then I put them in the toaster oven. They're out on the back patio because of the aroma while they're heating up. It's just heated up enough to where the spices stick to the chips.
Gotcha.
Roger's back.
But the reaper smell is awful.
Yeah, Shirley, you know, I'm doing real good, by the way. Want to know how the hell I was doing. I'm doing good. I'm doing good.
Okay, Google. I'm echo.
Really sore tonight. I was hiking all day today. I hiked to 2 different waterfalls today. I only hiked about 3.5-4 miles, but it was all rugged terrain.
Roger, you're creating an echo.
See you, Joran.
See you, Joran.
Good day.
Have a good day at work, Joran.
That's better. Thank you, Roger.
See you later, Joran.
What did I stop the channel?
I like your video, Ty.
The last one?
Yeah, that thing.
The fall hike, yeah. Oh, it was beautiful out there too that day.
It was. The Horseshoe Lake?
Pine Lake and Horseshoe, yeah.
The Horseshoe, yeah.
Yeah.
What state are you in?
Wisconsin, northern Wisconsin. Yeah, we, you know, right here in kind of up the northern half of Wisconsin, right up the center, it's all national forest. A lot of people don't realize Wisconsin's got a lot of rugged wilderness kind of terrain in it. Because most people just drive through Wisconsin. They don't stop except.
We got the same thing in Michigan where there are a lot of national forests and whatnot up there.
Yep. Oh, yeah.
But I think it's a little more hilly in Wisconsin, ain't it?
In the UP?
No, I'm not talking about the UP. I'm just talking, you know, you go north of my house, unless you're on I-75 to 23, there's nothing but woods, you know, dude, down the park. The upper part of this part of Michigan.
Right. The UP.
UP is gorgeous. That's all like waterfalls and stuff. So.
Yeah. Like, okay, you're in the upper half of lower Michigan.
I'm in the bottom half.
Oh, you're at the bottom half.
Yeah.
Okay, because I used to haul freight through Michigan all the time, and I love the country from Manistee north. It's just beautiful.
Oh, that's gorgeous country up there.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, that's like
I used to have to do business
in Alaska or somewhere. They've got, you know, gorgeous trees, you know, big, huge-ass trees. They got beautiful waterfalls, all sorts of stuff.
Yeah. See, now, here in northern Wisconsin, oh, we got our hilly terrain. In fact, that's what I didn't get to do it today. I was going to hike to the top of one of the it's called the Pinoki Mountains, Pinoki Mountain Range. I was going to hike up to a vista because of all the fall colors. And after hiking those waterfalls today and climbing cliffs and crap, my ankle hurt so damn bad. I looked up that hill and I'm going, yeah, now it does look like a mountain. maybe tomorrow. But yeah, all the UP and the top half of Michigan, all beautiful country. I used to have to go over to Traverse City twice a month for almost 5 years in a row, 4.5 years.
Roger, you're sweating.
Yeah,
of course.
Of course.
Yeah, of course.
Like, it doesn't matter what I eat, I sweat. Yeah. What I don't like about it, get stuck in your teeth. Don't bone your gums.
The sweat gets stuck in your teeth?
Yeah.
You know, maybe the corn.
I don't want to know where corn comes from, but yeah.
Wow, you know,
they got some nice bone to it.
Well, I've got to figure out where I can get my blue corn from, because the company I was getting it from, I couldn't get it from them anymore.
Well, can you buy it from a local store?
They don't have it here.
Oh, really? Okay. Yeah, I think Doritos have blue corn. Who else had them? The mom and pop. Well, I believe in the Chicago suburb, we got a lot more variety, but I've seen a lot of blue corn shipped out there. But
I'll have to figure it out.
Get on Amazon.
Unless I use the regular corn, but I like the blue corn.
You can always add the activated charcoal.
What's up, Purple Gang?
Nah. Well, that's what is in that pocket shield, is that
activated charcoal.
Yep.
We had a thought about using food coloring. Would that affect the flavor?
It wouldn't affect the flavor, but it would just
make it soggy. It'd
be kind of hard to get that right color.
Yeah, I could do it like a weird neon purple color or something.
Yeah.
Call it radioactive or something. I don't know.
Well, guys, it's after 1 o'clock. I gotta work it. My alarm's gonna go off in 5 hours.
All right, buddy.
I'm
always late, better late than ever.
Sherry, I don't know. Sherry's gonna cook. Are you gonna carry this over to your place?
Well, I gotta cook those jalapeno ranch chips. Right.
So before anybody leaves, let's see. Crazy Ann, you want to see if there's someone we can raid?
No, I can take a look.
Some.
Good night, Peppers.
I'm looking. Hard to find somebody this time of the morning.
Yeah. Yeah. It's usually Sherry that's up.
Right, easy.
But I will be making chips, so don't want to show my secret on my chips. Everybody see my recipe.
No,
I don't see anybody either.
Yeah, me either.
Are you going lifestyle or?
Oh heck, no! I'm going to bed. If we were to raid somebody, I'd go over there and leave them a thumbs up and watch for a while and then crash. I want to get back out in the woods tomorrow. So.
Roger needs to start going live.
I would be a boring host.
No, you wouldn't.
Yeah.
No,
I don't want to start taking my clothes off, dancing on the pole, you know, like what Phil would do.
We don't expect that, Roger.
Of course, we are
more sophisticated than that, Roger.
Of course, we are expecting that.
I'm everything spicy. You're just spicy. I'm everything.
You're everything, Phil. You're like an autumn, one of everything.
Phil, you just all out there.
Well, let's do this. We're going to anybody that wants to, we're going to go to GSHLTV. Hilo's there, Dojo's there. Hilo, Dojo, Laura's there. So we're going to do an Everything Spicy Raid on GSHLTV. Got to get me back up here.
But Phil, you're going to kind of let people know that you send them over there, what they do on that channel.
Yeah. Yeah, guys, I mean.
Maybe you shouldn't.
I put the link in there. If you guys, you know, I guess maybe not.
Am I missing something?
Yeah, it can get kind of racy over there. All
right. Is it drinking, singing, playing? Yeah.
Some of our friends are over there, but yeah.
If I could stay behind the chat room, I'd be all right.
Yeah, it is incredible.
Right. You're right.
Yeah. You're right. At your own risk.
Yeah. I took it off. Because I know, Phil, you've got a lot of PG people on your channel.
I do.
And
keep it PG. A little.
Because it's PG over there.
Yeah.
Thank you, Sherry. Thank you, Roger. Thank you.
I love you.
Everybody in the chat, thank you for coming.
Thanks, everybody.
Appreciate it.
See you later, Sherry.
Good night.
Good night, everybody. Sherry, Roger.
Love you all.
Love you, Ann.
Love you, Sherry.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Spicy panel and Spidey has to do a panel.